Throughout a series, a story is written, and depending on how much each side wants the win, decides the length and intensity that is contained inside the novel. This series has had everything. An injury to two star players for Deserano, which now puts the spotlight on some players who wouldn't normally get an opportunity in a situation like this. Graham Lehmers has been spectacular. He has received extra ice time and has thrived, scoring three massive goals while playing fantastic defense. He will be a guy on the Rideau's radar tonight. Another bright spot has been Greg Arnberg, a goal and three assists, and his defense has left Smith Falls shaking their heads on more than one occasion. Corey Kuypers and Dallas Slack have put on a goaltending clinic, and we expect the final chapter of this classic series will come down to goaltending. So let's turn the pages together and enjoy the end as we watch in real time an epic series in these EOSHL playoffs. The Bulldogs have lost star goalie to a possible season-ending injury. Insert the hot hand of Corey Kuypers. In Bailey Miracle's absence, Kuypers stopped 26 of 27 shots and followed that up with a 44-save performance and a 6-4 win in Game 4. During that win, the Bulldogs were without Mitch Gustafson, who was injured 8 minutes into Game 3. We at EOSHL want to wish a speedy recovery to the 5-tool forward. These two players have helped Deserano get to where they are this season. And so with all that, their counterpart has been getting fantastic goaltending as well from Dallas Slack. Calm and cool in the net and an elite puck-carrying goaltender. He's been stellar all season, and that continued into the playoffs. He is in good hands with Captain Brett Costello, a fantastic guy for the ice, and a terrific defensive IQ with Kyle Dowdall, Ben Beasley, Eric Witzel, Devin Cobalt, and company providing the offense. It will be a tall task for Chris Rogalski and the Deserano Bulldogs, even on home ice. We have all the action here on EOSHL TV next, folks. Let's send it down to ringside for O Canada.
Please rise if you're able and welcome Chase Casey to save the Canadian National Anthem.
From the dog pound in Deserano, the Bulldogs welcome the Smith Falls Rideaus for this fifth and final game to see who goes on to meet the Gananoque Islanders in the finals. Justin, it doesn't get bigger than this.
No, it doesn't. It's going to come down to a dogfight. No pun intended here, but it's going to come down to who's hungrier and who's going to want it more.
Well, both sides have incredible goaltending, and I really think that that's going to be a major part of the game, is goaltending. Which goalie stands on their head and wins the series for them? And I think it's going to be a low-scoring game, Justin. What do you think?
I don't know. Anything can happen in this series, as we know. Low-scoring could be a high-scoring. We don't know. It's like Russian roulette.
Right? We've really had both, haven't we?
Yeah, we've got a little bit of everything in this series. And you know, one of the big things in this series, it also comes down to discipline as well, and who's going to be the more disciplined team. Because as we know, Desaronno had a really great special teams performance last game.
Your goalies in each end of the ice. Corey Kuiper is a 6 GAA with an .885 save percentage of .351 and a .904 at the other end for Dallas Slack, as he makes his first save of the game to start to get warmed up. This ever-important Game 5. It's along the boards and up to McKenney. He'll throw it to the center ice area, and Dowdall knocked off the puck. Desaronno flips it up into center ice. Maybe a repeat of the same that went on in Game 4, where both teams were incredibly cautious coming out of their own zone. Back to the captain, Costello, looking to piggyback the offense to get them going early in this one. Pass cross ice, a long pass up to McKenney. And we got a puck that may never come back down again. It's right over us here at the EOSHL booth.
Right over my head.
You couldn't catch that one?
No, I mean, I should have kept my helmet on.
Draw just outside the Desaronno zone. It's scrummed back to the Smith Falls Ritos. Pass to the neutral zone. He was met there by Arnberg. That's going to be an icing. Number 11, Arnberg. The Desaronno Bulldogs has had himself an incredible playoff right now, with a goal and three assists. And on the defensive end, he's been as close to perfect as you can get. Along with the rest of his mates, they've really been pulling on the rope all together. And in this one, we'll see what they get and do. Well, they're negating, I guess, the icing. And it'll come to center ice for a faceoff. One back again to Smith Falls, as they've controlled the puck early. Or not a minute in, but they have been holding on to it very well. Really going in this, and Arnberg turns in his own zone. D to D pass, doesn't like what he saw up front. Well, they'll wait and move it out to center. The pass chipped in behind the net. Goes the great puck playing Dallas Slack. Good communication to dish it into the boards. Pass missed, goes to the blue line, and he's met with a nice hit there by Cannons. Cohen's first shift of the game. He's been great throughout the first four games of this series. Takes a hit there and keeps on trucking. Cobalt, nice pass over. Chipped along the glass and into the zone. A very sure-footed start to this game. Both teams feeling each other out. They know each other very well through the first four, but everything can change from one game to another. It's turned over. Desaronno shot towards the net, and it goes wide. Zach Masterson, number 7 for Desaronno in his first game of the playoffs. It's been a healthy scratch for the last few games, and he's inserted in the lineup. What does he bring to the game, Justin?
Masterson?
Yes.
Yeah, he brings a pesky type of personality to the ice. He's going to get in Dallas Slack's face all game, and he's going to be a havoc out there while he brings some very offensive skill out there.
He can be a game changer, thrown down in behind the net. Now turn it out to the point. Shot from the captain, it wrist shot blocked in the corner in front of the net, and Dallas Slack will find that one and hold on for the whistle.
As you saw right there, Masterson right in the in front of the blue paint.
As a goalie, you know that is one thing that can get inside your head, that one guy in front of the net all game.
You know, I just got to share a story here about Masterson. There was that game we did in Tweed where he was in Morrison's paint, and Morrison gave him the how do you do.
Yes, he was spun right around like the Sean Avery. Give him a lot of fits in close. What a nice pickup by Slack. He is cool as a cat already in this game, and he's hoping to backstop Smith Falls to play the Gananoque Islanders tomorrow in Gam.
Yeah, whoever goes into that matchup is going to have their hands full after the intensity of this game.
Going to be hard to rebound after this, a five-game elimination series, and it's passed up, and they got three. Walking in over the line, and it's turned over. Harrison booking it back to get back into that play. Smart play by him, and forced the offside.
I was in the room prior to the game and in the Bulldogs dressing room, and they had a lot of hype in that room, a lot of confidence, and the boys were just wanting to get the puck dropped and get going.
Oh, Well, the hardest part is getting into the game, to be honest with you. This is the easy part. Just use your instincts and play like the all-star you've been all season. That's dumped in. That'll be an icing. That was close to a penalty, but playoff-style hockey will negate that 2 minutes as it'll come all the way back. It'll come all the way back into the Deserano zone. Noah Brandt on the ice. Justin Allery calling out Noah Brandt in the last game to have a great game, and he did. Thought he would, and I think he had two.
He had a hat trick and one assist, so 4 points on the night.
Oh, yeah. I didn't ask you before the game, after the next whistle. Get it ready, Justin. Your spotlight of the game. Into the corner, trying to move it down and low, and they can't. There's Eastman, the ever dangerous Austin Eastman, turns it over at the blue line, dumped into the zone by Salter. Kuypers, feeling confident already, comes out to play a puck off the boards, and it's into the slot. Puck jumping around there. Shot goes towards the net, goes up into the mesh, and we got Justin Allery's Stars of the Game.
You know, for the Deserano Bulldogs here, I'm going to go with Jordan Cannons. You know, he's due for a big game here. And for Smith Balls, I'm going to go with... I will get to that back to you in a second.
Sounds good. Half-board shot towards the net. Misses the far side by Dowdall. Into the corner, and Sprague. He's got wicked mitts for passing. This is out of the zone, though, for Deserano with good speed. Dumps it in and a chase. Cannon's in to go get it. Slack throws it in behind the net and around. Mayer meets it there and throws it back to Arnberg. Arnberg will dump it back in. Turning back in is Miracle, forcing the issue. Red line and in. McKenney drop pass to Sprague. Sprague in front! Shoots and a goal. I don't know if he made the save or not, but a great pass in the slot goes astray.
I'm going to say here, Andrew McKenney is my choice here for the Smith Falls Fritos. He always seems to play very well whenever we're in the building.
McKenney has been fantastic throughout this entire series. I'm not going to bet on Sprague this time, even though he shot a lot in the last game. I'm going with your guy there, Witzel. He's been phenomenal through all three. But my bets don't even really matter because I'm never right anyways.
And not that we're encouraging betting.
No, not at all. We are not a betting station. But I seem to talk about it a lot behind the net.
If we were.
Through the neutral zone, it misses everybody, goes down the ice. Dowdall, look at the speed, uses the body, and a good play there by Hill to move it out. And down the ice they come with great speed, dumps it in, and Dallas Slack will hold on. I wanted to tell you something about Johnny Hill. I look at his whole season, four times he didn't get a point this entire year. Four games.
That's very rare.
That's a guy you talk about a lot, and I see why.
He talks about consistency he's had through the year. So, you know, that's about, 75% rate that he's picking up a point every game.
It's amazing. And, I mean, that's why he's leading the team in points.
Yeah, he's definitely over a point per game, but in terms of the not picking up a point, it's very rare.
1.9 on the season, leading the Deserano Bulldogs as a defenseman, a leader on the team. Masterson at the draw, looking to win it back, and he will. He's got to have fresh legs for this one, let me tell you. Throwing it in front of the net, and it's back to the point. And Cohen's, Rogalski, and they made a line change. Harrison on the ice now, chips it in. And a chase. Lamers in behind that net it goes, and it's up to the Harrison. Forecheck goes by him, Rogalski. Kuypers, he'll hold on for that one, and we'll get a whistle.
I've noticed here that Slack looks like he's fighting off the puck a lot off of a lot of shots, so we'll see. I'm sure that's going to calm itself down as the game goes on and he gets more clear shots towards the net.
Get himself settled in, feel a few shots. Both goalies covering. Oh, here's a chance and a shot, and Kuypers makes the save, and he'll hold on for the whistle. Corey Kuypers at the top of that blue paint.
Yeah, he's looking very sharp out there, very comfortable in the blue paint. And if I'm Deserano, that's great news.
And it's back to the top of the circle. They'll fire it towards the net, and it goes into the corner. After that, quick, Smith falls, a shot, hits a leg. And Rogalski, the captain, will throw it up blue line and out. Northgrave throwing it back to Costello. Costello on the half boards, and he can't get it out. It's offside. Racing after that is Mitchell Mary. He had an incredible big goal to bring it to overtime. He's allowing his club an opportunity. They're in. Great play. McKenney shoots, and what a great save by Kuypers to steer that one away. Cobalt throws it across, and they can't make it work. Back to the point this time. Northgrave threw a screen, hits a foot, and chipped away to the corner. Nice smart play by William Harrison to the point again. A shot through a screen, and he'll move it out to the blue line and into the neutral zone to thwart that opportunity. Costello, a nice little chip pass in, throws it towards the net, and Corey Kuypers again with a nice save, looking really confident in that crease.
Looks like the Smith Falls Rideau's game plan here is to throw shots on net from the point and take away Kuypers' eyes.
If you can't see it, you can't stop it. The old story. Corey Kuypers looking pretty good early on, and the Smith Falls Rideau's the Deseronto Bulldogs into the slot shot, and Kuypers again comes up with a beauty to the happiness of this crowd.
Right now it looks like shoot often.
Get up to 70, 80 shots a game in this game. Keep going this way.
Yeah, luckily it's not the peg and, hopefully it's not, the Rockets playing peg and falls.
Yeah, that was a wild game. What was the number again?
That 80? Was, 91 shots in the entire game.
91 shots, unreal.
On one side.
Under the middle. Watasek finally found out his name. Thank you, Calvin. Through the mid-ice area is Eastman. He'll walk in on goal. The backhand towards the net, and the scrum in front of the net. Eastman trying the wraparound. It's knocked off his stick. Thrown up and into the mesh. It looks like they're trying to kill us tonight, let me tell you. That looks like it's going to go for 2 minutes. Looks like it went straight.
I think the referees here are going to have a little huddle and see what the call is. It might be a delayed game.
Looks like it went straight out, didn't it?
It looked like, unless they had a different view, it looked like it maybe went off the boards and then out.
I didn't hear a board. I didn't hear it. Did?
Like it hit the ceiling.
That thing we've been talking about so much.
We've been talking about it, Billy.
It's got to change.
A delayed game penalty in those circumstances.
100%. Noah Brand. No, that's Cannons. The draw, it goes behind the net. Bailey Miracle giving chase. Good stick lift there. Looking in front of the net. He's knocked off the puck. Thrown up. Looking for a penalty there. They'll go back to the point. It's Arnberg. Shot redirected. And Dallas Slack will make that save. And hold on. What a deflection there. And it looks like Cannons is hunting down goals for you already, Justin.
Yeah, I thought that was going in from the looks of the position of that tip. But we know Slack, he's sharp every time he's on the ice.
Tremendous goalie. He's one of those elite goaltenders in this league, and we've got many of them. He is one we're lucky to see here in this final game five. Into the slot, goes back to the point, and it's held in and shipped into the corner. Mayer, he'll go in to grab it. Knocked off the pass, goes astray, and up goes Dowdall. Slick little pass to Sprague. He tries to give it back to him. It's turned back the other way. Costello bodied his man along the boards. Trying to dig it out, and they will. And it just goes to the point, and a shot towards the net, deflected away. And Costello will hold on to it behind the net. 13 minutes and 5 seconds to go here in the first period. Shot. Oh, it just missed the net there. And goes wide. Shot redirected in front, and Kuypers makes the save. Ripped up the boards. Neutral zone. Mayer. Pass through. That's going to be offside. Nope. They'll leave it alone. Good, smart play. Up to the mid-ice area. McKenney will just lose that one, and Sprague will throw it on goal. Stopped by Kuypers. That was a tough one to see. Drilled along the boards. Dowdall shoots, and he missed the far side. North Gray from the point, he'll shoot it, and Kuypers directs it up into the mesh, and it'll come down for a whistle inside the Deseronto zone. 12:31 remaining here in the first period. Kuypers needing a moment. Is that a puck? I think there was a puck caught up in his pads there. I'll have to check the replay as he pulled a puck out of his pad. Face off inside the zone. Scrum face off into the corner. Cohen's going after Sprague. Bodies him against the wall. Sprague gets it to his man. Cobalt is thrown away. And up is Masterson. Ever dangerous. Throws it on net. And Dallas Slack will hold on to the whistle. Well, both these clubs have battled through 4 games. One game at 8 goals in the first period, 2 for the next 2. Then Smith Falls came out with 5 goals in the first period in game 2 to show that they are here. And they can score too. Draw to the half boards, tried to just fire that on net. It's knocked off the puck by Masterson, trying to move it towards the net. A good defensive play by the Rideau's. Chipped up into neutral ice, neutral zone by Morton. thrown into the zone. Back down it comes by Barr. Behind the net, Smith Falls trying to set up. Morton playing a lot of minutes in this first part of this game. Really good defenseman for Smith Falls as he's waiting it out. They've got a couple guys up at the blue line come back to help him. Now he has some options. A pass that'll miss. Costello and go down the ice for a faceoff. Cobalt.
Been pretty quiet here. It's just got really crowded over here.
Absolutely. This place is standing room only. And if you look around, I've never seen it hook all the way around both boards like it is. It's all the way over here. They're sitting two back over in the one corner.
It's good to see.
It really is.
Into the slot area and another cover. You can tell both teams are playing this game smart. Neither one wants to make a stupid play. That's why there's so many face-offs.
There's going to be a point in this game where a team has to start taking chances and opening it up.
Can't wait for that. Draw for Mitchell Mary. We'll look to get something going. Draw one into the corner. Good stick there. Chopped into the slot. On that quickly. They'll move it out to center ice. Wiley.
Into the
slot and a shot stopped by Dallas Slack. Good opportunity. Slot again. Shoots and it rolled on his stick. He'll drill him into the boards. Hold him against the wall. Wiley, number 27. It's into the slot area. And Dallas Slack will slow that down enough for his guys to pick it up. Throw it up through center ice. Cohens. Rogalski. Hard pass. And back. Into the Smith Falls zone. Keeley. Good pass through center. Hits a stick. And icing's negated. Behind the net. They'll try and move it out. And they will. Off the end of his stick by Brandt. Good play by Hines in. Oh, tried the pass over to Eastman. And Dallas Slack will hold on again for a whistle.
Yeah, just a lot of pucks rolling in on that. And like you said, it's just it's a very conservative hockey right now.
Well, I'll tell you, it's hard to describe the atmosphere here. It's so full and anticipation is high, but it seems very quiet right now with a nothing game halfway through.
It's nervous, really. It feels a little nervous in here.
It really does. A chance now for Eastman. He'll throw it across. Shot from the point, and it doesn't get through. Hines spins in the corner, trying to come out with it. He is being harassed by Northgrave. Smart play and good D. Good support by Sprague. Throwing it up to the neutral zone, and it's picked off. They'll hold on to it and try and get it into the zone. Smith Falls with a DDD pass, throws it up. McKinney, what a pass, and Sprague's in, shoots! Kuypers comes up big, and he keeps it nothing on a break play. What a save.
Kuypers, he's playing confident, and you can tell that just in the way he's just staying cool, calm, collective in that blue paint.
100%. We figured if a goal went in on either goalie in the beginning, it could be a massively high score, but these guys look like they are ready to go. Nerves don't exist in this arena. Cannons gets it across the blue line, tries to chip it in. It goes to Costello right up into his chest, and he's out through center to Sprague. He gains the zone and behind the net, tries to throw it out in front. The cross pass misses the receiver. Sprague shoots, and Kuypers deflected that, I think. Yep, up. Into the mesh. Draw come inside the zone. 9:46 to go in this intense classic and an incredible series between the Bulldogs and the Ritos. We've had a privilege bringing it to you, and we're sad to see it end, to be totally honest with you.
Yeah, and this series has been what this league is about. You know, any team could be anybody. I mean, this is a primetime game. Oh, look at that great puck handling by Slack. Ooh, I just soccer kicked that puck.
Tell me you're in the game without saying anything. Nice pass across ice. They're into the zone, and it's Johnny Hill throwing it up the ice to Masterson. It'll go right down to Dallas Slack, and he'll hold on to the faceoff.
that right there, that deserves a highlight all on its own.
All the draws deep inside the zone. The Smith Falls Ritos will try and get her out to keep it at a nothing game. To the left of Dallas Slack. Scrum back into the corner, knifed along the boards to Madison, back to the point. Fred score! Lamers, the backhander, and the Deserano Bulldogs are up to a 1-goal lead early on. To the happiness of this
packed house here at the Dog Pound.
That's how you beat Dallas Slack. You just got to fire pucks on that in low, create the rebounds, and that's how you beat them. There's no chance on for Dallas Slack to make that save on the rebound.
Graham Lamers potting another one. He had two back-to-back the other night in Smith Falls, and they just keep dropping for him. Great hockey by number 92. Dumped in around the boards, and Dallas Slack there to meet it, off the glass and around. It's met by a Bulldog. Mitchell Mary is there as well. Try and bring this crowd to their feet one more time. Labeled along the boards. Scrum. Knocked down from behind. Lift there. Back to the point. And they're out. Turns back into his own zone. Kenny will throw it across ice. Up. Ice by Cobalt. To Cobalt. And he's met with a good hit there. Turns the puck over to Mary. Mary to the ever-dangerous Hill, Johnny Hill. He'll wait. Wholesale change by the Ritos. Johnny Hill slowly comes out of his zone. A little chip pass, hits a stick, and comes down right onto Hines' stick. He's got himself a shot as well. Always got to be careful of him. He can find the open man, and the open man doesn't know he's open. Drop pass. Into the slot. And a good chance there. Goes astray. Hines brings it out. What a pass. And it's beautiful. Picked off by Northgrave. He drills a shot. Whistles it wide of the net. And comes back to Austin Eastman. And this could be trouble. He's in. Tries to go around the defender. He'll keep going. Keeps the puck out. Win puck protect. Nice play there to go around him. And he can't. He'll still pick it up and throw it in behind the net to Hines. Hines throws it into the slot. And the Ritos will thwart that opportunity and bring it out to center ice. Walking in on goal and a chance. Shot and a big save by Kuypers. Throwing it up to the center ice, Harry and in. Walking his cannons around the D. Backhand towards the net. And Dallas Slack with the paddle down. Old style there with the paddle down to make the save.
It's always a safe play when you put the paddle down. You don't want sneaking through.
.720 to go here in the period. It's thrown behind the net. Miracle will be there to meet it. But so will two Smith Falls Ritos. And a penalty coming to Miracle here on that one. That was a little interference as well. Maybe 2 minutes. Miracle will go to the box. Uncharacteristic of Miracle. Good tough hockey. Looks like a hook or a...
I think I saw them signal for a high stick, it looked like. I didn't quite see it. I don't know if I saw the ref's arm just go up. It looked like it was, I guess we'll find out the call in a second here, but I think it might be a high stick.
I knew he was harassing him with the stick, but I wasn't sure if it was a hook or a slash, one or the other, and a high stick to boot.
I guess we'll find out in just a second.
Very dangerous right now as the Smith Falls Ritos in the power play is something you don't want to mess around with. And Deserano gets it out early. Harrison is chasing that puck down. See if he can make something happen on a short-handed effort. See if these Ritos can knot it up at one. What a speedy doubt all around. Three guys behind the net looking in front. And he goes to the point to Sprague. Back into the corner. Back to Sprague again at the point. Costello. Shot towards the net. Kuypers kicks that out right to Mary. And he backhands it into the zone. Dallas Slack comes out to play with a .125 to go. And the speedy Sprague to the neutral zone now. Walking in, gets around two Deserano Bulldogs, and he'll throw it back out and down the ice. And they'll kill another 40 seconds on this puck.
Notably missing from the lineup is Eric Witzel from Smith Falls. He's a very big key part of their power play and their penalty kill, and he's not in the lineup today.
Well, that is not good. Thrown behind the net and around. We'll have to figure out why he's not in the lineup. It's got to be an injury or a personal thing. Thrown down the ice. Slack will grab it. He's got time, and they got a wholesale change coming from Deserano. Arnberg now. Smart play to stay on the ice as that fourth player. Make sure there's one. Defend the net. Thrown. Hits a foot. 39 seconds remaining in the power play, and Smith Falls is having a lot of problems that they didn't have in the first four games on this power play. Oh, what a hit. And
keep
that, yes, it is.
But it's also
what Tassick there. Nice play. It's into the corner now. Back to the point it comes. Over now, Smith Falls setting up really well in the shot. Can't get through the rebounds there. Great defense by the Bulldogs. Back to the point it comes. Crossover shot through, hits a stick even, and it's stopped and goes behind the net. Back to the point, thrown in deep and low. Pins him against the wall. Around goes Cobalt. Try and move the puck down low. Spun off the play, hit behind the net. The power play's over. And Deserano now, the goal scorer. Lamers will dump it out to center ice, see if they can get a line change. And a smart play by Lamers as he stays on the ice. He was the one who dumped it in, and he probably wants a change more than anybody. He stayed on the ice. Good smart play to the half court. Short pass as he fans on it, and it's Sprague to the slot. Great stick work there by Cohens. Through is Lamers. Drops it back. No, it's taken away. And Costello tries the long pass. And he had Dowd all to his right. Another turnover. Sprague in on goal. Drop pass to the slot. Dowd all stopped by Kuypers. What a save. Deserano with three straight uncharacteristic turnovers almost results in a goal. But Corey Kuypers comes up big again for his mates.
Not sure if it's butterflies or if it's just getting a little too comfortable on the ice and creating those passes, but it's definitely one of those unforced errors.
Incredibly uncharacteristic.
Very much.
Eastman, draw back, and Johnny Hill, if you're ever going to start a play, a rebound from a couple bad passes, Johnny Hill's the one. Yeah, that sauce pass up, hits Eastman, and Eastman will go around a man and gain the blue line. He's in, goes into the slot area, knocked off the puck. And it will not be a call. This crowd wanted one in the early going for their side. Nice move around, and it's stopped by Kuypers again. Bunch of Bulldogs behind the net to dig that one out to Hines. A little sift pass over to Eastman, and he'll move through the zone swiftly. Stops up, feeds the pass across ice. He'll get it. And Johnny Hill throws it towards the net. The rebound. And Dallas Slack will keep the legs closed and it will stay out.
I had lost sight of the puck there for a moment. It was so quick.
This period has flown by. 3 minutes and 26 seconds remaining in this first period.
We're definitely getting robbed of our time, Billy.
I'm telling you, that big interview I got tomorrow, I'm going to talk to him about that. We need to extend it to 30-minute periods. Back behind the net, and it goes up to, I can't see who it was, it's into the slot again, it's out. Bailey, or Miracle, throws it up, and they get it, and they're in. Cannons, he's got a chance. Cannons throws it towards the net, deflected up and into the wood. Wetasek. Draw inside the zone. 3:08 to go here in the first period. Deserano Bulldogs send out. Really tough line to the Smith Falls Ritos to continue. And pass back. And they go behind the net. Pass up to Wetasek. Costello will drill it into the boards. It's drilled around Boyce Clare. Ironberg throws it around the boards. And it comes up to America. Good stiff pass, and they're into the neutral zone. This Smith Falls defense is really making it difficult for Deserano to get anything going. That one goal early on has really been big for them because you got to get out on a good foot, especially against Smith Falls. They're a team that can score in bunches, so is Deserano. So we can never count either team out, and we never know what we're going to expect when we get to the hockey arena. I'll tell you that much. Zach Masterson wins it. Shot, and it's kicked right out by Dallas Slack on that one. The neutral zone, and Deserano will dump it back in around to Slack. Slack holding on to it. He didn't really have anybody, and it's chipped by Costello up through the neutral zone, and away they come. Cobalt in, into the slot shot. What a save by Kuypers. The rebounds whistled wide and back to the point. Here comes Costello. Shoots, and he whistled that high and wide. Chipped around him. It's a breakaway for Zach Masterson. Score! Welcome back, number 7, Zach Masterson. And the Deserano Bulldogs are up by 2.
Yeah, he's got his presence known on the ice.
Didn't take long.
Zach Attack is back.
Unbelievable. Well, I was thinking when you told me that he was back in the lineup, that might help ease the absence of Mitch Gustafson and adds a little bit of scoring and a bit of grit. But as long as we were talking before the game, he stays between the lines and doesn't take a lot of penalties. He's going to be a really big help for the Bulldogs in this game 5.
Yeah, Masterson, he's very well known as like a villain to a lot of the opposing teams he plays against, but he does such a good job at it.
And shot wide of the net and goes behind, hits the back of the net, and out comes Smith Ball. Whips it up, stays in the arena, hits the boards, and comes down to Sprague stick into the slot. Kuypers keeps it out. Unreal save by Corey Kuypers. Do you believe it?
I don't believe it. I mean, I should say I do believe it. He's playing phenomenal, and just last game he took a shot at an empty net, and you can tell like how confident his game is right now for a goalie to pull something like that. You know, he's playing with a full confidence.
You've got to love that as a goalie, seeing the backup really come in and play like a number one. It's beautiful to see. Pass back for Smith Falls. They got to calm this Deserano team down and get a goal of their own. That's not going to be an icing as it hits Sprague on the other side of the red line. Rogalski rips it around the boards, chipped up and in. They're away through the neutral zone, and Hines with a nice move around the man. He'll get into the corner. Tries to throw it out in front. Knocked away. Hines boarded by Sprague. Throws it back behind. Comes almost out in front of the net and chip. Dowd all there. Pick that one up. Knocked down and chipped back into the corner. Hines in behind the net. A good body, and he'll regain the puck. Hines waiting for his mates as they made a big change, and he's getting tattooed behind the net there. What a great effort by Hines. Thrown across to Sprague. They'll gain the blue line. The shot! Score! Andrew Sprague, my guy, I thought was going to be the big one the other night, and tonight he shows me he can snipe. Short side, and it's 2-1 with 45 to go.
Yeah, well, you've been saying this whole series, he needs to shoot the puck more because he's got a laser of a shot, and there we just witnessed it right there as he scored that big goal.
That had no room to get in. Kuypers at the top of the crease, and it's really deflating as a goalie, especially when it's shot short side.
Yeah, for a moment there, I thought he was actually going to drop for a pass or slide it across, but he fooled me.
Not for 1 second did I think he was shooting that puck. Mayer, he'll dump it in and around the net, and Dallas Slack will come out to play it. He rips it. What a smart play. But it's taken away. Dumped back into the zone. Costello spins in the corner, and he throws it up to the blue line, and it's out. And down the ice. Top of the circle, toe drag into the slot. What a great save. Kuypers, stone cold in that net. Hit on the boards was Johnny Hill. Good play by Watasik. The corner now, and a good pull. Oh boy, that is going to be a penalty. That was from behind, and that could be more than two. And that'll end the period. And they'll go to the second with a boarding call. And a 2-1 lead by the Deserano Bulldogs in front of this sold-out crowd at the Dog Pound. Justin, this first period was special, man.
Yeah, it was. It's definitely what we were expecting of this type of scenario that we're in a do-or-die game. And we're going to see a lot more of it in the second period.
Can't wait to do it and bring it to you here on EOSHL-TV again. 2-1 Deserano. We'll be back. For every team, there's one game that makes or breaks their season, and some teams it's early on. For many, it comes in the last few games, but when it arrives, you can feel it, and it turns that game into the most important 60 minutes you've ever played for both of these teams. That's what's in front of them for this next 20 minutes. One game decides who will go on to meet the Gananoque Islanders in the West Finals. It would be an honor for both sides to represent their conference, and both are deserving of the privilege. But who will it be? Through the first 20 minutes. We've got ourselves a one-goal lead for the Deserano Bulldogs. And the shots on goal throughout the first period, 23 Deserano, 22 Smith Falls. The goal scorers, Graham Lamers again on the score sheet. And the assist came from Peyton Gauthier and Zach Masterson. And then Masterson on the breakaway scored to get his second point of the game. Andrew Sprague and Samuel Tremblay and Kyle Dowdall got Smith Falls on the score sheet. Justin, Zach Masterson was awarded the assist on the first goal. That's 2 points for him early on in this one. What did you see from either side in the first 20?
Well, we saw both the teams playing very conservative. You know, really, we saw a lot of shots from far hitting the net, but not a lot of real big scoring chances up until, I'd say, like towards like the back half of that period. But overall, we're starting to see both teams really opening up offensively, taking chances, and I think we're going to start seeing a little bit more of that in the second period. We also saw Smith Falls almost tie the game late there as well.
Well, and Kuypers, I got to be honest with you, I'm really surprised at his goaltending. It is amazing. In this big game, he's showing zero signs of nerves.
Yeah, and you know what they say about goaltending is it's 80% mental, and the rest of it's all, the rest of it is your ability, right? Skill and ability.
100%. It's all in your head. And we got the second period coming up in 3 minutes and 40 seconds, folks. Grab yourself a drink, because it is quite a game we've got going on here at the Dog Pound. We got one final. The Rockets beat the Mustangs 6-1 in their game one of the finals. We're going to have game two tomorrow, live possibly from South Stormont. I can't wait to do that game as well.
Yeah, we know South Stormont is going to be rocking. They're going to have a sold-out crowd down there, so it's going to be noisy.
They're saying they had to hold on to some tickets and stop selling them online because they were going to be sold out before the game started.
Yeah, they wanted to keep some tickets available for some of those who come to the door. But it's going to be rowdy there, Billy. I know you've never been there before, but I'm going to tell you, it's going to be a party.
I can't wait. It's like out there in Tweed and Barry's Bay and here tonight in Deserano. I don't think that you could get another person in here. And as you showed, they're lining the arena and almost too deep. Over in that corner, they're really too deep. And that's got to be nice for the Bulldogs and Smith Falls to play in front of.
Yeah, I mean, realistically speaking, we have fans almost on the visiting team's bench.
Well, we're set for puck drop in this ever-important deciding game. Who goes on to the finals and who goes home to think about their season? A 2-minute power play for the Bulldogs to start this second period. 2-1 lead. Noah Brandt on that first. Can't hold on. It's breakaway. Sprague in. He's knocked off the puck. And he runs right into Kuypers, and he's down. He held it out of the net. But we've got a 2-minute tripping call to the Bulldogs on that one.
Yeah, that didn't look very good there, but it looks like Kuypers is all right. Doesn't look like he's in any kind of discomfort, so that's good news. We do have Brady Sayers in on the bench today, so he's in there with Deserano for though, in case if there's ever a situation to arise, they've got a solid backup option.
Say, I thought that I recognized him in the warm-ups when you're out there with the old GoPro.
Yeah, he's happy to be here in Deserano. He was mentioning to me that he was disappointed that he couldn't be more available for Frontenac this year just due to work and commitment, but he's just happy to be back playing hockey.
That play's knocked down by Eastman. He'll move it up to center ice to Hill. Hines quickly. Hines towards the net, redirect goes wide. Eastman with that long reach and that great stride makes him dangerous every time the puck gets near him. 1 minute and 22 seconds, and we'll be playing a short 5-on-4 for the Ritos. 4-on-4 hockey right now. Both teams need to be... What a play. Nice move to get around him. Doesn't know what to do with it now, though, as Eastman stick lifts him. They got a 2-on-1 with Hines breaking in. Tried to get across the second one. Really should have pumped that towards the net. He's trying to be unselfish and make a beautiful play. You never fault that, let me tell you. Here in Deserano, they know how to move that puck. Smart play by Hill. Trying to wind down this 4-on-4, and he'll move in. Hill, the drop pass. Ooh, slick to Eastman. Grover, and a shot. A slap pass. Just missed the wide-open cage. Cohen's into his own corner, being chased down by McKinney. Goes behind the net in a little sift. Very dangerous play as it's almost turned back. 30 seconds remaining in the Smith Falls penalty. To the neutral zone, to Cannons. He'll get across the blue line and stop, turn back, and he'll throw it back down low. Rogalski onto the far side, throws it back in. Smith Falls, long ice pass. Andrew Sprague, move, and he scores! Andrew Sprague, you give him the second chance, and he'll bury it most of the time. Sprague with two in this one.
What are we witnessing here, Billy? If we were betting people, you know, we wouldn't have bet him having at least two shots on net here.
Absolutely. All I had to do was just not say he was going to score, and bang, he just starts firing that puck. He's got great eyes. I'll grant him that 100%, but his shot is lethal, and he needs to be a little more unselfish.
Yeah, and you know, you can see how silky his mitts were on that. He beat Kuiper's 5-hole on that. Good on him. You can tell he's playing with tons of confidence, and the way he's skating up ice with tons of speed.
It's not an easy thing to do to beat Kuiper's between the legs. The shot through, and Kuiper's easily holds on to that one. Sprague at 8 goals and 11 assists in the regular season. He's right up near the top of Smith Falls leaderboard, and that's the reason why right there. You can find the holes. 12 seconds. They got a power play to take the lead here against Deserano early on in the second period. Little problem with the ice. I'll try and make a little effort to fix that. Cobalt at the draw. He's got Costello to his right at the point.
Looks like the referees here are doing some little repairs to the ice here, as there might be a hole in the ice that needs repairs.
How there could be anything wrong with this ice. It's so cold in here, but it's perfect. Like, it's not freezing cold, but the ice, from what I understand, is always great here in Deserano.
It always is. I mean, it's just a safety precaution, of course. As you know, one little nick in the skate and someone could go flying.
There's something
can be broken.
Absolutely, 100%. Back to the point, and Costello will move it past Zach Masterson. Walking him along the boards is Cobalt. He goes behind the net, and this penalty is over. Back to the point, and Tremblay will move it down to the half boards, into the corner almost. Shot, and Kuiper's saw that somehow and made a brilliant glove save on that one. Wasn't flashy, but it was beautiful.
I would have failed the eye test on that one for sure.
I couldn't believe he's seen it. And so calmly, just bing. Well, they're 5-a-side now. Cobalt at the draw. He's got Spencer Cobalt to his right as well. Scrum face off, and it's 1-4. Smith Falls. I'll throw it to the point to set up, and the referee in the way will kick it outside the zone. We'll come back in offside. Masterson will receive the pass and gain the line. A ripping shot, stop by Slack. Masterson back to Rogalski, handcuffs him as he was striding back to the blue line. DDD, Rogalski rips a pass on the right-hand side. You know, rip it on net, just up and over. Masterson will bring that down to his stick, goes to the slot. And they'll turn and set it up inside their own zone. Try to make something happen here in the second period of this ever-important game for either side. Their seasons have built to this, really, to get to the finals and represent their conference in the conference-versus-conference battle.
Yeah, whoever wins this game, they're going to have a very big battle up against Jake Pement and the Gananoque Islanders.
It's going to be a wicked battle. Either team so deserving. They'll gain the line. Johnny Hill will drill it on net, and it almost handcuffs Slack. He tightened up the arm and makes the save. He'll hold on for the whistle. People are still filing in and trying to find places to sit. This is unreal. Very nice to see for Deserano and their community. The draw is one back to Smith Falls. It's dug into the half boards, and they're out, and it's the ever-dangerous on-fire Andrew Sprague deking in, looking, throwing it to the slot. Come back the other way, McKinney. No, Dowdall muscled off the puck, and they're out the other way now. Deserano with good speed. Harrison fakes the shot, looks to the slot, the redirect. Just goes wide of the net.
into the corner. Goes Arnberg, bodies his man against the wall, throws it back down. And there's Northgrave. He's hit again by Arnberg. He has been spectacular in this series. Mitchell Mary looking to fire that one. It's off his stick, and Costello, the captain, throws it into the far corner. McKenney will drill it towards the net and easily steered aside by Corey Kuypers. Goes back to the point. Nobody there. Tremblay will reset. And they'll try it again. Nice move through by Hill. Chipped into the zone. And they'll make a line change. 15-50 to go here in the second. And it's across the blue line. Sprague is bodied, but he stays on his feet. Across! Score! What a second ago, and it's a 3-2 Smith Falls lead on that fancy little play. Sprague will get his third point of the night. That nice took the hit, gets rewarded, and that's the old story.
Deserol's going to have their hands full right now, looking at trying to beat Dallas Slack here, being down by a goal. So right now, Smith Falls is playing the exact game they want to play right now.
Going to be a crazy battle to get out of this one here. The Deserano Bulldogs put up a 2-goal lead early. 3 unanswered now by Smith Falls. Brandt fires it, hits a defenseman's leg. Watasek. Laying it out center ice, around the boards. Picked up now by Tremblay, an offside indicated. And Hines has to leave the zone. And they're walking in. Boys Clare will drill it around the net. Kuypers can't play that one as it bounces over his stick into the slot. It's back the other way. Hines, the pass to Eastman, gains the blue line, shot towards the net, tried to redirect. Again, it goes astray. Great hit by Brandt. Good forecheck by Deserano here. Dumped out to center ice, and it'll go into the Bulldog zone. Try and regroup and get her going. A good couple slashes right on the stick. It will not be a penalty. It's knocked off. Cohen's stick off the glass to center ice and picked up, knocked down by Hines. He is really going. Shot, hits a leg, he'll get it again. Shot towards the net, the rebound's there. Comes back, and Mayers didn't see it. Circling, finding the open man, and there he is. Miracle across the shot, and it's stopped by Slack. Outside the net, that was boarded against the wall. No touch of the puck, spinning back. Miracle again. Throwing it down low, nobody in that right side. Great play there. Cannons coming back to the half boards. Ooh, Sauce pass over. The shot gets through, and it's stopped by Dallas Slack and held on for the whistle.
Smith Falls is doing exactly what they want to do in their defensive zone, keeping the shots to the outside, give the goalie a chance to see the shot and freeze the puck.
It's great hockey and really smart plays. Burt and Shaw in the lineup for the Deserano Bulldogs as he comes off the ice. He is an electrifying hockey player, and he had a great shift there. Connor Burtonshaw, watch his number as it sifted back out in front of the net. Connor Cannons to the point. Arnberg drills one, stop by Slack as he's top of the paint. And a beauty save there. McKenney, a cross pass up. What a nice little play by Cobalt. He's in on goal, drilled it, and it's off the heel of his stick. Into the corner for Smith Falls as they're buzzing. Chance again, shoots, and it's just wide of the net. Mayer, sip pass to the neutral zone. Cannons just out of his reach. It's played off the boards and into the neutral zone for Deserano to shoot it in on Slack. And leave it for Tremblay. Tremblay turns back the other way. This game is back and forth each time. Both teams looking to get a chance and score, and that one just offside.
Deserano just has to keep their feet moving and generate chances, because right now it looks like they're watching Smith Falls entering their zone, and it's costing them dearly right now.
It's like they're stuck in mud. It feels like they're not using their speed, they're not moving the puck as quickly, and that's a result of the incredible defense by Smith Falls, clogging up every single lane.
Now, we know of one guy on the ice right now that is always moving his feet, Zach Masterson. You know, he's always got a rocket in his bonnet.
A guy can score, offensive threat. Smith Falls will have to try and contain him for the rest of this game. He's been in on both goals, just like Andrew Sprague's been in on all 3 goals for the Smith Falls Ritos. Neutral zone,
Good move by Masterson, and he's in. What a pass over. Shot, and he ripped it over the net. Rogalski drills it, and it's deflected wide and into the corner. Chop puck. Cohens reads it and brings it in. Backhand pass goes astray. Good defensive play by Masterson there. Cohens turns in the neutral zone, and he'll dump it off the glass and in. And Masterson is the first one for Desirano to get there, but he's moved around by Smith Falls. They drill it through the neutral zone. They're in. Sprague again. The hot hand shot. Kuypers stops it and holds on. And Sprague is firing on all cylinders in this one.
Yeah, and as you saw in that last sequence there, everybody's motor was going. They're generating a good scoring chance there by Masterson. And again, he's going to be a big factor in this game moving forward.
The next goal's on his stick. Draw from Mary. Lost. Pass over, shot towards the net, rebound chance, and it just goes wide of the net. Harrison chips it through center, and they've got a room dumped into the zone. Slack will chip it into the corner. Wiley pinned against the wall. Smith Falls trying to dig it out. It'll come to Desirano. Shot, Burton shot deflected, and the rebound sat there. Slack makes that beauty save. A shot by Burton Shaw to Wiley. 12:05 to go here in the second. A 3-2 Desirano, 3-2 Smith Falls lead.
That was a very close call there. The official's doing a great job at directing traffic out there, calling the players to move the puck. These guys in stripes, they're unsung heroes in this league, and without them, we wouldn't be having these games.
Couldn't agree more. They don't get the respect they deserve. The pass to the slots taken away by Smith Falls, and they're out. Watasek. Jeez, I'm having a hard time even with his name. Watasek.
Yeah.
Jeez. Drives me nuts. I keep wanting to call him Watasek. I don't know. Sorry, Calvin. Thank you for the name, brother. The draw inside the zone. Eastman smoothly wins that back. They had a lot of forwards on the right-hand side. It'll go to Smith Falls. And it's knifed out through. For Desirano, it's Hines with great speed now. Blowing in on goal, turning back. That was blocked up. Slot shot up and over wide of the net. They're just missing the net right now for Desirano, trying to replace the top shelf. Chipped in around Eastman. Slick play there. Great forecheck. Eastman on the slot. He can't get his stick on that one. And it'll go out to center ice and down the ice. It'll be an icing against the Smith Falls Redos.
Smith Falls doing a great job at tying up the stick there in the high danger situation. They are just playing their game defensively, and just they're limiting Desirano's offensive opportunities.
Got to be really strong to tie up Eastman in front of that net.
Oh yes, Eastman is in a league of his own. He just knows how to get the offense going.
Shot and it hit his foot and cannons. That must have hit a spot that had no padding. Shot towards the net. Some cannons did not like that one. Back to the point, knocked down low, top of the circle, pass over. Mayer scores! Mayer, short side, and it's tied at 3. We're almost at the halfway point, and we've restarted this game again. Holy Dinah, what a goal.
I can tell you, he's got a snipe. I played a men's league game against Joey Mayer. Let me tell you, he lit me up like a Christmas tree.
You're too hard on yourself. Tell them all about the glove saves you made on him.
Yeah, there's maybe a few.
Draw one back to Smith Falls, and they'll try and recover.
There's definitely more goals than there were glove saves.
Shot stopped by Kuypers, and he'll hold on for the whistle.
Yeah, we're squared up at one here. Now let's see who's willing to take the chances.
Masterson over the boards now. It's going to be a big situation for Desirano.
Vernosi is getting a lot of ice time right now with the way he's been playing. So Coach Steve Durant here is doing a great job with seeing who's going to get the much-deserved ice time in this critical time of the game.
Back to the point, a chance for North Gravy. Shoots it wide, and it almost comes out right at you. Oh, my! We're... Corey Kuypers, do you believe it? And he makes another one. The shot goes back towards the net. Kuypers making 4 incredible saves. D to D, Northgray, back down low. The shot stopped by Kuypers again. Unbelievable goaltending.
trying to get it out. They can't control. Wow, what a bunch of saves that was.
Did we just witness Dominic Hasek?
Reborn in Corey Kuiper's image. Do you believe it? Collins, he's knocked down and just body contact. Thrown into the zone. It'll go offside. It's starting to heat up now, Justin. Halfway point, 2 seconds past.
I saw goosebumps from that sequence. You know, he is having to give Kuipers a lot of credit. Looks like he's fixing his mask, and I think he may have took one off the mask because he's was adjusting his straps there.
That sequence for a goalie is so scary. The shot goes back behind the board, squirts out to a wide open guy, dives over. I think he might have made the save. If not, it goes wide to a wide open guy again.
And that's makes a key, like just huge key save there, never, and keeps his team tied.
Never gave up on it and kept going.
Draw one back now, Deserano. They'll look to break open the 4-3 lead for them. Thrown up the ice. Mary will drill it in. A smart play there. Wiley gets there first. He's pinned against the wall. He can't fend off two Ritos. It's into the mid-ice area, and Deserano looking to pick that off, and he can't. Good speed by Harrison. Chips it in. A smart play around the man. And he tried to chip it in again. He falls. Smith falls. He'll pick it up. Thrown back the other way. Pilon up to the boards. It's kept in. Burton's shot takes a hit and put it on net. Harrison throws it to Mary. A smart play there to keep control. Burton Shaw thought of it, but thought better. Going in to help his forwards on that one. Makes the play as they got two Bulldogs back. Good pass up. They'll try and start it out again. Good pass again by Burton Shaw, and they're in. Nice pass over. Eastman, stopped by Slack. He's got a rebound chance, tries to throw it out in front. He will. Burton Shaw shoots, and it's kicked out by Dallas Slack. Good hit by Burton Shaw to the corner. Pilon takes the hit and loses the puck in the slot. Stopped by Dallas Slack. It's down the ice, and it'll go for icing. A goalie battle ensues in game five.
This is exactly the kind of hockey and the kind of game that I was hoping we would see. A goaltending goal with two great netminders.
It's never a disappointment when the goalies are coming up with stellar saves, folks, let me tell you. I don't even think you could pick a goalie that's hotter right now. They're both playing so well.
Yeah, you really, you know, again, it's kind of disappointing that the series is coming to an end tonight.
Really is. Next season, these two teams will have a rivalry built that'll last forever. After this game five series, it's pinned against the wall. Feels like an eternity. The refs tell them to move it. Let's go. Get the play moving. Can't hold it there forever. And they're trying, running out this clock. And it's still stuck there. I can't see who's holding it up, but it's out and down the ice and in the neutral zone for Dez, giving chase. Nice sip pass. Hill. Hines gains the blue line. Sift and slot. Branch stopped by Dallas Slack. A wicked save with the pad on that one. And Slack will hold that one. Give her a stop behind the net. Stoppage of play. A little rough stuff after the whistle.
I will say this right now. I'm missing the video quality of James right now. He's, you know... This, you know, I definitely do not live up to the hype that James Bull brings every time he is behind the camera.
Oh, he's a legend. He gets the job done very well. And near miss tonight there, son. We'll see you soon. Hopefully tomorrow in South Stormont. Draw. Cannons will lose that one. And Smith Falls will try and move it out. Great bodies, but he's lifted on that one. Down low. Cannons again looking to the point. He'll throw it into the slot. It just goes wide. Long ice pass. In on goal. Cobalt spins, looking low, and drill it behind the net. McKenny is bodied against the wall in the corner. Held along there. Maybe they'll get it out quicker this time, and they do. Ironberg onto the half boards. Mayer meets his man into the slot area and moved up and out. And Deserano. Mayer throws it into the corner, and Cannons is there first. He'll meet his man and take the puck. Shot on goal, and it hits the defenseman. It's in front of the net again, and Miracle just missed that one. Cycles it back down. Mayer turns in the corner, knocked down, and the fans wanted a penalty on that one. Into the slot again. It's backhanded out through neutral zone and in. Cobalt
with great speed. Drop pass, ripped a shot by McKinney, up and into the mesh. And it'll come down for a face-off. What about that?
And we got 3 points on the field goal there.
Add it to the scoreboard. Let's go. Oh, are we looking for another OT, Justin? What do you think, buddy?
It's going to come down to the wire, Billy. I think it's going to come down to the final moments of the third period that's going to determine this game.
Scrum draw and into the corner. Chipped along the boards. Drilled against the wall, and they're out with good speed. There he is. Lamers across the blue line, shoots. It's a stick. He almost caught that, and a stick. Rogalski shot. How? It's in. No, no. It's not a goal. They thought it was in the net, into the slot, and they can't pick it up. Rogalski throws it down low. I didn't see what the fuss was about, and the fans behind the net said it was in, but it definitely didn't cross the red paint. Smith Falls looking to come out with it. Deserano is pressing hard now, and a big hit. Cohens chips it up to where Zach Masterson is. Now he backhands it in. He'll pick it up again. Throws it into the slot. Tried the stick lift. That would have been incredible on Costello. Smith Falls Ritos will try and regroup, bring it back to their own zone. They can't. They're being pressured so bad. Coming out is Patterson. He's got good speed. And a knack for the net and a shot stopped by Kuipers. He'll hold on for the whistle. And Rogalski shoves him away to not create any problems.
Some nervous moments there if I'm Dallas Slack and I hear a bunch of people cheering. You know, good on him for staying with it.
100%. Did you see where it went?
I did not. I just saw the puck kind of bouncing in the vicinity of the area of the net. But I didn't see if it went in or not. But we'll have to take a look at it afterwards.
100%. Good thing we got the camera here to figure out what went on in a play that nobody saw. Slot shot. It's stopped by the defender. Hill, long ice pass. Yeah, touched his stick.
No ice.
No, he called it an ice. Looked like Wiley had touched it, but he's not complaining too much, so I don't think it hit his stick.
Yeah, generally just by the body language there. I think the refs probably made the right call.
I couldn't agree more. And Sprague on the ice now. He's got 3 points, two of them goals. One was a beauty way to take the hit and make the play, and he's got the receiving area up into the slot, and a chance by McKinney. Great D, point. Pilon shoots it, hits the heel of his stick, and it's knocked down by Hill. He'll throw it up again. Wiley can't knock that one down. McKinney in the neutral zone. A good stick lift there. Pass negated. Dowdall back to Pilon. Over to Costello. Good long pass to Sprague, and it's just out of his reach, and they're back with Harrison into the slot. Mary shoots. It hits a stick and goes wide. Good play. Harrison throws it into the slot. They're making a line change. They're back down the ice, and McKinney just missed that one. I'm a breakaway. Try and throw it out in front to Dowdall. Back around the net it goes. Noah Brandt. Sure-footed as a billy goat. Throws it up the ice. That's going to go down for an icing. And we'll bring it all the way back. I like the no-touch icing in some ways, but on a play like that, not too keen on it at all.
Yeah, especially when the other team isn't hustling as hard. And they know that icing is going to come back the other way. I agree with you on that. Wave it off if there's no hustle.
100%. I couldn't agree more.
Austin Eastman at the draw, looking to get something going. Against Cobalt, and it's one back for Deserano. A long ice pass again, this time it connects. A good drop pass there. Hines avoids his own player at the blue line. A couple good slashes on the stick, and Noah Brandt was tied up in front of the net and couldn't convert on the cross ice pass. Behind the net it goes and around. Back in front of the net, and it just goes wide. Hill fakes the shot, throws it into the corner. In front of the net! Stop by Dallas Slack, and he'll hold on with 4:09 to go.
Very dangerous. Noah Brandt left open in front of the net there. Anything can happen there.
It's hard to move him as it is, but you got to have a body on him to try and smack that stick out of his hand if you can.
Especially after the hat trick performance from the last game. You do not want to leave him open in front.
The draw inside Smith Falls zone. Very important. It's one, and Smith Falls is out, and with it, they go. With great speed, McKinney was knocked on the seat of his pants. I don't know about that. knocked down in the corner. Behind the net is three Bulldogs, and the Ritos come out with him. He's drilled against the wall. McKinney trying to throw it out in front of the net, and he can't. The backhand pass goes right into McKinney's feet. He can't get it, but miracle. And a line change for the Ritos on a 3-on-2, 4-on-2 shot, and he goes high and wide. You gotta hit the net on that one. Must have rolled on him for a second. Dowdall shot, and he missed the net, goes out in between Kuiper's legs. The control, Sprague to the point, a bouncing puck comes outside the line, and he throws it right back in. Kuiper's around the boards, and they'll have time to move it out now. Waiting and waiting. Pass to Miracle. He'll try and get it in. Knocked down by Costello. Mayer will find it. Would have been better just to leave it there for Burton Shaw. The shot hits a leg and a great defensive play there. Trying to hit him in the boards. He gets the puck instead. Smith falls, being pinned along the wall. Good play there to get it out. Pass up through the neutral zone into his feet, and he gathers it. Mayer looking to beat his D-man. Going to the net. Around it he goes. To the slot, and it's chipped away by Costello calmly, as the captain will do. Cohen's. 2 minutes, 37 to go in the second period. Rogalski chipped into the zone. Masterson fresh off the bench. So is his whole line as they just get out here. The corner looking to turn with it. He'll throw it back behind the net to Zach Masterson. He goes to the slot area and it will not hit a player. It goes out to center ice. Drilled back in around the boards. Lamers coming in. Oh, what a big hit. That was a nice one. They're back the other way they come. Cross ice pass. Tries to throw it down low. It gets knocked off. It's sticking to the slot area. Shoots. Stopped by Kuipers. What a nice pick there by Hines. Hines, a 1-on-4, 2-on-4, shoots it in and avoids the hit. That was the important part. But it got clocked. Back the other way they come again with good speed through the neutral zone. Shot stopped by Kuipers. Used the D as a defensive screen. Drilled along the wall. Up the ice is Eastman. He's hard to catch, but they do it somehow. In the zone, knocked off the puck, put back into the corner. Pilon will go after it. Buck and a quarter, minus a penny. We go to the third period, and it's tied right now at 3, and we got an icing to bring it down with 1:16 to go.
This has been a very physical period, and you know, there's been no penalties called. It's been a very, very clean game. A lot of clean hits being thrown, but this is exactly what you want to see in the playoffs.
Elite officiating, because these guys are treading along that line between penalty and great play. And the refs are letting them play. You have to love that.
A lot of great puck battles that we've been seeing all game long.
Chipped in, and Arnberg takes a hit from Watasek. Watasek, a nice play there to Cobalt, or Boisclair, sorry. Boisclair along the wall there. Kim moves it to Arnberg, and he's out for Deserano with a guy down behind the net. Deserano with good speed, Miracle. Ooh, it just rolled off his stick. It's back the other way to Patterson. He gains the blue line, drops it back. Good play by Cobalt, looking down low and he can't meet him. Boisclair, the corner, knocked off the puck. Deserano caught standing still right now. Arnberg chips it to the point and shot through. Goes wide of the net. Miracle. Good drill on the wall there to try and get the puck back. It's back behind the net. 25 seconds remaining here in the second period. Miracle chip it out to center ice. And both teams wanting to go to the third period, at least tied, across the blue line. And they are really backing up. It's not Deserano style right here. Drilled along the wall. They're out in front of the net. And Kuipers jumps on that one. That sequence felt like they were just, their feet weren't moving.
Yeah, and
they're running out of the period.
When your feet aren't moving, bad things are going to happen.
100%. You're saying Masterson's a guy who can never be charged with that as a play of his own, but with 7 seconds remaining, they'll bring out Eastman, Brandt, and Hines to try and end this period and keep it at 3.
This is a critical face-off coming up right here. Sprague's on the ice. Maybe we'll see a shot off the draw. Who knows? But, you know, a draw up to a point and a 1T. Oh, here we go.
Into the half-boards corner. Point. Chance. Costello. Shot. and it's knocked down in front. And if it could get any more intense, I don't know how it could be. 3-3, going to 3, a tie, Justin.
Yeah, you know, it's definitely... I'm lost for words, Billy. Honestly, not the first time I've said that. But this has been everything that we have hoped for. A very tight, well-played hockey game. Not a lot of penalties. Very physical. And, you know, we're going to be in for an exciting finish to this game.
When you're going into the third period, and the fans are definitely getting their money's worth. You know it's been a wang doodle of a hockey game. And we've been treated to 40 minutes of great hockey. So we'll go to the break, folks. We will be back with the third period. A game 5, 3-3 between the Deserano Bulldogs and the Smith Falls Ritos. Stay with us, folks. Through 40 minutes, we're no closer to a winner than we were 40 minutes ago. They just won't allow this game to be uninteresting or this series. Shots on goal, 19-18 for Smith Falls. The goals make it a 3-3 score, with these two clubs battling to the final second. Goals in the period. Andrew Sprague getting his second goal of the night from Mitchell Keeley. Calvin Watasek with a goal, assisted by Kyle Dowdall. Andrew Sprague the assist. And Joey Mayer from Brody Miracle and Mitchell Mary. Justin, I don't even want to ask you what we're in store for, because we have no idea.
We really don't. That's what makes this whole series so much fun, is all our predictions have been wrong. So don't bet on what we're saying, but I will say this, bet on a great outcome here, and whoever wins here, it's you know, you're going to see a big celebration.
For both sides, this is do or die, and the last 20 starts for one of these teams. Both have had great seasons. It's sad to see it end, but Eastman shot, and he ripped it high and over the net. I'll tell you, the game right now for Deserano is to fire that puck high, as they missed a few times up top. Shot from the point. Because Dallas Slack is so great down low, they've got to risk it and go up top. Back behind the net it comes. It's knocked away, and Smith Falls will try and move it out. Costello lets that go to Dowdall. Dowdall ripped a pass way up the ice. It will come down and be a draw back inside the Smith Falls zone. Early on in this period, you can see Deserano is chomping at the bit to get that first goal. Smith Falls looking to counter with their great defense that's really thwarted this Deserano onslaught to the first four games and 40 minutes of this one. It's not the same Deserano team throughout the regular season. They really manhandled a lot of the teams they played. And Smith Falls is putting on a great show here for the Rito faithful. Kuypers holding on to it a little bit long. Now under pressure is Deserano in their own zone, but they trying to get it out. Hits a leg. It comes back the other way. Dowdall lost it. But there's Cobalt walking across the line. Ripped a shot. Stopped by Kuypers. Glove. That was a tough angle, and Kuypers made a beautiful save on that one.
A lot of sharp angle shots I'm noticing on Kuypers. I don't know if they're trying to catch him off guard. Maybe not hugging his post as tightly. Sometimes those can sneak through.
Thinking the same thing. The draw is one, and Mayers collects. Good, smart play up. What a beautiful play in Miracle. Oh, Dallas Slack with a save on that one. Bodied against the boards, to the point. Cohen's through a screen, hits the Smith Falls defender. Trying to dig it out. Smith Falls will, along the boards, and out to center ice they come. On a two-on-one, shoots! Kuypers with the save on that one. Oh my, what a save. Keep it at 3-3. Digging in the corner, getting drilled pretty heavy is Miracle, and he gets it out to his mate Cohen's. He'll move it up through center ice and in on goal. Drop pass. Masterson into the corner. Dumps it behind the net. Cohen's again as he's jumped up in this rush. It's behind a Masterson. He can't step it home. Dallas Slack was all over that one.
For $920, 9341-8357.
There's only been 2 minutes and 5 out of this period. And it's already been an incredible start to the third. The pass, Peterson is drilled along the boards and back around Patterson, through to Masters. A backhand pass goes to the neutral zone, and he's in on goal. Oh, what a move! And he just lost the handle at the last second, and he's battling again. Smith Falls will bring it out to center ice. Throw it across to Costello. He gains the zone. Walks in, dropping the slot, shoots, and a save by Kuypers. What a stop there. They're back the other way. On goal shot. Hits a leg and goes into the corner. We'll try and gather. Drilled back to the point. He'll hold on, wait for an angle. Shot deflected just wide of the net. Dowdall throwing it up. Cobalt. That's a smart play there. Thrown in, and Kuypers will kick that one out. Getting good positioning on him there. Trying to move it into the corner, and around the net they come. Ironbird chipping it off the boards and out. I heard a board on that one. Goes into the Deserano bench. 16:49 to go in this epic game five between the Bulldogs and the Ritos. Both clubs deserving of that finals ticket, but only one will be booked. It's in his feet. Good play there to shovel it off to the boards by Northgrave. Dowdall in his own zone. DDD pass it over to Pilon. He'll drill it into the zone. Kuypers steers it to his own defenseman. A smart play there. Goes in behind the net. Ironberg the pass over. Throws it up. Neutral zone and in. Sprague will pick it up. Two goals and an assist in this one tonight. Back into the corner it goes. Smith Falls trying to regroup as Eastman throws it to Noah Brandt and just out of the reach. Off the boards and down the ice, and we'll bring it back in the Smith Falls zone. Both clubs playing their game close to the chest in this third period.
I'm really eager to see when they want to start opening up their play a little bit, maybe take some risks. With risk, high risk, there comes big reward, right?
It can't be nerves by now, eh?
No, I mean, realistically here, I'm wondering who has more pressure. Do you have Deserano who's playing at home in front of their home faithful? You know, they want to go and play and again, all play tomorrow. But then you got Smith Falls too, right? They want to be the spoiler.
Sprague with speed, had to turn back. He's offside, Dowdall. DDD pass and thrown back behind the net it goes. Smith Falls being pressured in their own zone. That's knife to the point, a chance for Mayer. He'll lose the handle. It goes back to the point again. Thrown into the corner. Deserano. Slot. Shoots. And he didn't get all that one. And it's stopped by Slack.
Slack looks so cool in that net right now. Nothing is really bothering him. You know, any traffic in front of the net, he looks like he has ice water running through his veins.
He really does. And that's what makes a great goalie, like your buddy Price.
Yeah, exactly. Or, you know, Felix Potvin, minus the weird stance with the glove. All these goalies had one thing in common, is you got to have ice water in your veins.
It's one thing I love is that the goalies have changed that hand, their glove facing towards them. Around him he goes. Stops. Cobalt to the point. Tremblay the shot. The rebound for Keeley. Threw a screen, and it hit his foot, and it went in the net, and it's a goal. Smith Falls finds the back of the net, and they're treated to a 4-3 lead. I wasn't sure if they were calling that back or not, Justin.
I'm not sure, but that's a real backbreaker right there.
That redirect, it was not a kicking motion. It just hit his foot and went in the net, and Deserano finds himself behind by one.
Sometimes it's just the luck of where the puck goes, right?
Masterson with Lamers to his right. It's one to Rogalski. Over to Hill, to Lamers, to Masterson. He can't get a puck on his stick. Patterson back the other way. Towards the net, Kuypers with a nice save, and he'll hold on for the whistle. And he'll bring her down inside the zone to the right of Kuypers. Face off. Back. Peterson shoots, stopped by Kuypers, coming up big again for Deserano to keep him within one with over a half, three quarters of a period to go. And Deserano really got to start pressing. They're on their heels a little bit here. Masterson, a great draw to kick it into the corner. Onto the half wall and out. And away they come. Lamers throws it in around the net, and a good play by Costello to just get himself in the way. Good hit on the boards by Lamers again. Masterson checks Costello. It's around to the blue line, and it'll get out. A massive battle ensues, and Smith falls. It's a hand pass. Watasek looking to move that out, and he's going, it was me, it was my hand, to myself.
I'm just happy we learned how to say this guy's name.
So am I. I keep looking down to the name, though, to make sure I'm saying it right.
It just has a great hockey. It's just a great hockey name, isn't it?
Watasek. Draw for Eastman. On to Smith Falls. Noah Brandt to Eastman. He'll gain the blue line. Backhander up and over the net to the point, kept in. Nice play by Burton Shaw. Hines drilled along the wall, but he comes out with the puck. And there's Dowdall with a nice slick play up to McKenney. McKenney across the blue line. He's looking in front of that net. And he's taken out of the play. A beautiful work. Sprague to the point. Tremblay, Keeley shoots. Kuypers makes the save. Hines there to pick that puck up to Brandt. Brandt throws it up ice over his stick, but he's got a chance to get it. Dallas Slack will hold on to the faceoff. 13:41 to go here in this ever-intense Game 5.
Right now, Deserano can't afford to give up another goal. They can't afford to be down by two right now. That would be a feat that would be very difficult to come back from.
Draw. Scrum. Point shot. It hits a stick, goes up, hits the wood. We'll come back down. We'll have ourselves another faceoff. Mayer, Hill, Arnberg. Cannons, Justin's pick of the game. And on the left is looks like Miracle. Draw one back to Smith Falls. They'll control the puck. Almost turn it over, but they'll get it out to center ice. Deserano will turn it back the other way now. Arnberg avoids a hit and gets across the blue line. No fear in his game. Shoots it wide of the net. And they'll keep it. And the penalty is coming to the Smith Falls Ritos.
That's our first penalty we've seen in a long time.
I don't think there was one in that second period. I'll have to look. It has been a while.
Yeah, the last period penalty I think we saw was at the end of the first period where there was that boarding call.
Oh, no, there was one at the 16
that's right.
Seconds in to negate that power play. There's been three total.
That's
in
right.
Season. Draw one back to the point. Hill will gain the zone and come in to the slot. No, sir. It's a skate, goes back to the point, and Sprague chips it by Eastman, and he's got wheels. Sprague stopping, trying to go around him, and great defensive play by Arnberg. Don't worry about the puck, take the man. There it is. Sprague is getting 2 minutes. Oh no, that was not a good penalty for Smith Falls. Back to the point, Hill to Brandt. Shot hits a leg. They're wasting a lot of the net is empty. Oh, and they're wasting the penalty. Back to the point again. Brandt shoots a rolling puck wide of the net. 1:20. And they finally touch it, and they blow it dead. You could hear the fans up here telling them, give them the puck. And after that, three shots missed the net, and they wasted a good 15, 20 seconds of that power play.
Yeah, you know, it's one of those things where it's like you just got to have a heads up, you know, be heads up on that. But I think Deserano's more or less, we still have the extra attacker on the ice with the goalie pulled. But, you know, we got a big, important 5-on-3 coming up here. Sprague here taking a very costly penalty, undisciplined on that case, but we'll see if this results in a goal.
200 feet away from your own net is never a good penalty.
We got another penalty.
And that one, I didn't see it. Is that on Smith Falls?
It looks like it's coming to Deserano.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, that's three straight penalties to Smith Falls, but Deserano's getting two. And so that is going to be devastating to the Bulldogs.
4-on-3, there's going to be a lot of open ice here. This, honestly, I sometimes think 4-on-3 power plays are a lot more dangerous than a 5-on-3.
Couldn't agree more. Eastman lost the draw, but won it at the same time. Hill coming out of his own zone. A nice pass to Eastman. Rolls on him a bit. And the fans don't like that one. And they're starting to get upset with the refs now on the home side of the ice.
Yeah, I didn't quite see if the puck made its way out yet, but there's a lot of fans in the building who disagree.
100%. There's almost 1,000 referees in the stands, and they saw it differently. And that puck will go into the half boards, and Desirano will try and set up Brandt. DDD pass to Johnny Hill. Cross over to Eastman. Eastman to the point again. Hill cross pass to the dot, and he tries to get it over. He does. To the slot. Shoot! Score! The laser shot into the top shelf where mom keeps the peanut butter, and the Desirano Bulldogs have made it 4-4, old baby.
He timed that little arrow right to the net. Little Robin Hood action.
Oh, yes. Coming in to save his mates. And I can't believe how good Johnny Hill is. He is such a great point producing and phenomenal defenseman. It's amazing.
Oh, yeah. What's there to say about this guy? He's just phenomenal. He's a smooth skater. And we got a beautiful save there by Corey Kuypers. Johnny Hill, that celebration, he's an archer out there.
That was really slick. That was wild. That just broke down. Desirano's been pressing Smith Falls to get that goal, and then all of a sudden Smith Falls breaks through them like a hot knife through butter. Desirano's really got to figure it out. They got a goal. Now get back to hockey and find the next one. The draws one into the corner, and McKinney trying to pick that one up. He can't. Back to the half wall, into the corner, and Masterson will try and set this one up. Masterson shoots it in on Dallas Slack, and he makes a save. And what happened there?
Right in the middle of it, right there, is Zach Masterson in the front of the net. Took a little run at Dallas Slack there, and as we know, that's his game.
They call a bounty on that?
I don't think so, but Slack's mask is off right now.
Your Desirano Bulldogs goal scored by number 22, Johnny Hill.
Johnny Hill being announced as a goal. That setup was absolutely beautiful. And well deserving of the goal. This crowd gives the cheer they should, because that was a beauty goal. No call on the play. 54 seconds remaining in the penalty to. Still 4-on-4 here for a long period of time, trying to throw it. What a great battle there. Going to go to the point. Back down low again. Around the net, Mayer's the first one there. Turns back into the corner and slips away from the defender. He's in behind the net, being held up there. And I don't know. Back to the point. Ironberg onto the half wall and knifed out to center ice. Cobalt. Sift across, shot and a save! Corey Kuypers comes up big again, as he has since inserted for Bailey Miracle. Corey Kuypers, a gold star behind his name in this one.
I just love the swag after he froze the puck. He just got up, threw the puck away, and skated to the corner.
That's when you know he's in the zone and you don't want to bug him. Unbelievable. Into the corner. Dowd all hit against the wall, and Johnny Hill not liking that. The holding right now is Desirano is not enjoying. Masterson with nice speed in. He'll just put it on, ripped it wide. Sift behind the net, trying to get control. They can't, and it's Johnny Hill. The back pedaling Zach Masterson. Lose that puck. He's got three of them on him. He'll throw it off the boards and out and down the ice. Well, we've been treated to five incredible games. Why should this one be any different? A half a period to go, 4-4, back and forth action and back and forth goals. It hasn't been separated by more than two goals this whole game.
Yeah, you know what? I'm going to say this, Billy. We have 8 goals in this game so far. That first period in game one, there was 8 goals in that first period alone. So.
And they followed it up with 8.
Yeah.
The next game, Smith Falls scored 5, and I think Deserano had 2 or 3 at least. They're in behind the net, digging for that puck. It's a black puck, but it should be gold right now. They would kill for that thing. It's back to Costello, and a shot through. Corey Kuypers with a phenomenal save. It looked like a lot of net there for a second. From here.
Yeah, it definitely looked like a lot of net from my vantage point here. Kuypers did a great job of just sealing it off and tracking that puck.
Oh, one of the most important draws of the game with 9:57 to go. Draw one of the point, and it's Costello, D to D. Northgrave throws it into the corner. It goes around the net. Back to the point. Shot. Into the corner and around the net. Up into the neutral zone. Chipped in and around the net. Throws it to the front of the net and he can't get it to go. Mayer to the point. Johnny Hill walks in. He gets his stick lifted. Oh, and a high stick to Cohens as well. And it's back the other way. Break, score! Smith Falls comes out, fires another one home, and they're up by 1. Trip and fall, and Smith Falls with 9:21 to go. They come out with a 1-goal lead.
Every game he has popped up a puck, and they've given them 3 goals.
The fans are not happy right now. They want their boys to come back and make a goal. Pass inside the zone. Thrown up and into the zone. Sprague gets in. Shot and stopped by Kuypers. Nice play to get it to the point. Shot through and it's stopped by Kuypers. We talked this
It's a thing, it's each game, same guy, just popped up a puck, it's frustrating, it's really so bad, and then drop the bouncing puck, I was like, oh, he's doing great, I thought he said, oh, keep going, it's great.
It adds the aura of the hockey game.
Yeah, it adds that element. It's beautiful. To the point, the shot through, and Kuypers makes another save. 8:56 to go. I sadly missed what he did in that corner. I was looking up here because there was something scrum going on over here. I thought the play was dead.
Yeah.
Did he fall? You didn't see it either. That is wild. I did not see that play. Sorry, folks at home. I hope you got to see it. It's around the net.
And so, so crowded in here.
It is. It is wild. Onto the boards. And out. And Noah Brandt, the pass across to Eastman. He's in on goal. Shot! And he just missed the top shelf. Hines throws it into the corner behind the net. Cohens will go and get it. Cohens looking to the point. And he can't. Brandt back behind the net. It goes. Eastman coming out of the corner. Knife back to the point. He'll try and keep it in. A great defensive play by Rogalski, and he turns it over. McKenney stops at the blue line. Noah Brandt turns it back the other way. It's a 3-on-2. Noah Brandt, oh, Sprague caught up to the slot, and he can't make that go. Cohens throws it back in to the half board, spins around the defender. Brandt to the slot. Chance stopped by Slack, and it's sitting there, and it's down to Kuypers. Kuypers throws a long pass up to Eastman, and it's an offside. 7:56 to go, Justin. How can it get more intense than this?
Hey, we just had a moment there with Rogalski having a cross check on one of the Reno's players. I didn't say who it was, but he didn't look very happy.
Absolutely not. It's getting violent now. The boys are getting wild and riled up. They know in 7:56 their season's either over or they're moving to the finals.
Or we're going to overtime.
And here's a chance for miracle. And another one zings over the net. It goes so into the...
As a goalie, you hear those.
Yeah, they whistle. Miracle trying to hold down Costello behind his net, but he slips away and he's got it across the blue line and in the zone. Shot, Kuypers stops it. And he ran the goalie and Kuypers not happy with that one. It's been a couple of them now. Dallas Slack got hit. Kuypers has been hit twice.
And this is getting pretty good penalty or stick broken as well. Both sides getting very heated.
Hey, this is playoff hockey, baby.
100%. It's everyone in. Well, intense in the dictionary just shows two logos, Cerritos and the Deserano Bulldogs. Treated these fans to some incredible hockey throughout the season, but nothing compares to this five-game series. Disappointing, one of them is going to go home for the season and regroup for next year, but the other one will find some jubilation in a W here tonight.
The other thing too is, one of these teams is going to, have some really tough decisions to make in the offseason, while the other one moves on.
Johnny Hill, DDD pass to Arnberg. Pass goes up, knocked down, drilled in around the net. Dallas Slack thought better of coming out for that one. Good play there by Mitchell Merry. Chipped off the boards and almost came back up over the net. Forcing the issue is the Bulldogs. Their season is on the line. Thrown through center ice and it goes down. It will not be an icing. Johnny Hill goes into the corner, trying to get out of their own zone. 7 minutes remaining in the third. Masterson with speed, and he's across the blue line, and he'll shoot it low. Dallas Slack comes up with that one, and they're just piling onto their goalie there, shoving the guy into their own net. Oh, my. She's getting a little bit wild here at the arena.
In the middle of it, I think I know who's on the bottom of that pile.
Was it Masterson that got knocked into the goalie?
I think so.
That wasn't his fault, though. To be honest, there was the shot. Actually, Masterson, I think, made the slap of the puck when it was under his pad. And the
guy's right there. He wasn't under the pile.
No.
But I will say, I got to give a lot of credit here to Dallas Slack. He's kept his cool this entire time.
He always looks like he's just zoned right in every time we're out. What's an elite goaltender. And Kuiper's showing he can go toe-to-toe with Dallas Slack, making some spectacular saves of his own. When the chips are down, that's when you find really what kind of goalie you have.
Yeah, exactly. And, I'm going to say whoever gets to go toe-to-toe with Jake Clement tomorrow, it's going to be a duel.
Absolutely. Draw one back into the corner. And around the net. Deserano digs for it. Hines can't get it through the defender, and a great play to get it back behind the net, and Smith Falls is out with it. Eastman, good back check, rubs out Dowdall. It's not easy to do. Good pass over to Hines, or to Brandt, put it on. Dallas Slack will gobble that one up and make that. That's an easy save for him. Maybe looking for a rebound or something. But.
Yeah, sometimes those shots along the ice can really, really handcuff you and catch you off guard. So good on the players, they're trying something different.
And low. I've noticed they're going high so much and missing the net by a good foot and a half. Shoots! Score!
Andrew Sandbelly.
Unbelievable! The Snipe beats him top shelf. And it's a 5-5 tie. Oh, baby, what a goal.
As you were just saying about shooting the puck along the ice, well, clearly that one was not along the ice. Again, do not go with what we say.
Never listen to us.
Never listen to us.
Listen to our words, but don't ever take it.
Just go the opposite direction.
Absolutely. Make it a 5-5 tie. This crowd is just incensed by that. Little miss, Miracle, good body to take him off the puck. And they have life in their step now. 6:14 to go. Deserano trying to buzz their way to the final. Chip along the boards, they'll get it in, but Costello will knock that one down. The pass to the neutral zone, and Cobalt in on goal to the slot. What a stop by Kuipers. Unreal. Turning at the blue line towards the net. Knocks him down. Burtenshaw knocks him off the puck. Burtenshaw coming out. What a on his Tate Cobalt rips a shot, and what a save by Corey Kuipers on a turnover. That is going to cause a penalty.
And this attendance, it feels like it's 21,000 people in here.
It really does. It's hard to hear yourself think.
And we've got a power play coming up for Desmerado. Listen to this crowd.
Wow. Devin Cobalt going for two.
I will say this, one player that we would love to see on the ice today, Mitch Gustafson. That's one player, these Bulldogs faithful would love to see out there right now, and especially in a crucial moment like this.
He's a steady hand and he does a great job on the power play, but Eastman, he's going to have to try and get the job done on the draw, and he will, but Brandt can't sift it back to Hill with Arnberg beside him. What a great play by Johnny Hill. Noah Brandt, as it's an offside. They also got out there Hines. That's the five for Desirano with 5:25 to go and 1:43 in the power play. Desirano wanting to call them all back to their own zone. Arnberg wants them to set up, and it's turned over. Oh, my word. Hines, he'll stop now, and he'll move it back out. The puck rolling on him, gets it to settle down. Good pass to Eastman. Eastman gains the blue line. Stops and gives it back to Brandt. No, he keeps it. Eastman turning into the slot. Brandt scores! Noah Brandt, they'll take the lead. 6-5. Oh, baby, what a goal. They are going crazy here at the Dog Pound.
Noah Brandt, he is absolutely electric in these big moments.
Well, you heard from the crowd, that's what the best player does. He's a fan favorite here in Desirano. I don't know who the best player is, but he's loved here in the Dog Pound. Wow, what a game.
I'm losing my voice, Billy.
I am too.
But I can only imagine how you're feeling right now.
Cancel tomorrow. Costello gains the red line and dumps it in around the net. Kuipers throws it along the wall, gets to the half boards, and Rogalski will throw it up. And Desirano looks to move it out. Great speed in the 3-on-2, looking to break in on goal to the slot. No, it rolls and it goes back to the point. Cohens throws it low. Masterson picks it up, loses it, and it goes into the corner. What a pass! Shoots! Way high and up and into the wood, and it'll be brought down. I think he just missed that. And
yeah, piece of that.
I don't think so. I think, yeah, he did. It's right outside the zone.
Okay.
He just wired that high. I think it flipped on end on him and went high and into the wood. I'm going to pass out. Hollering so much. Feel great about it, though.
Gains the line. Hines into the corner. He's knocked down. That will not be called. Definitely not this late in the game. A 4:05 to go in the third. Turns. Cohen's a good play to go against the grain. Sifted into the zone. And there's... what a stick. Oh, it's knocked off his puck in there. Can't do nothing with it. It's dumped into the zone. The clock winding down. Smith falls out of their own zone, trying to make the right play. Good hit on the boards by Cohens. He holds on to his stick. Gets up into his pants. And sitting on it. Thrown back to the point. It's out. Tremblay couldn't hold on to that one. D-to-D pass. And it'll look like an opportunity for Smith Falls to get out of their zone as they turn it over. Keeley, cross over to Dowdle, through the neutral zone, pass across, is knocked away. What a pass, play in. Hines looking to make something happen here. Turns on his defender, back the other way he goes, looking to the point. He'll hold on to it to try and wind down some of this clock. Back around to the point, and it's Arnberg. Throws it back down to Hines as he's pinned and drilled along the wall. And they're not calling that one. This is playoff Vaz. Hockey Zach Masterson, he's lifted. What a sick and a goal. Tries to get it through his legs. Knocked off the puck. Masterson digging for it. Desirano. He is everywhere in this ice surface and here in the Dog Pound. Turns at the blue line. Throwing it back as they'll get possession just before. Too many men would be called. chipped in to the zone by Lamers.
That's a high stick, and it'll be brought back outside the zone with 2 minutes, 23 seconds to go. Smith Falls needs to find one.
Yeah, right now, Desarono's playing with full control right now in their game. You know, Smith Falls, they need to start taking some big chances here. And we're going to be looking at probably for a timeout really soon.
Yeah, definitely.
Get themselves together.
Tremblay. Pass over. Patterson. Throws it behind the net. Kuypers just missed that one. It's into the corner. Walks out with it. Smith Falls has not been in the Desarono zone very much in this game to control, but they've got it now. Tremblay, a shot, hits a stick, goes up, hits the glass, and comes back around to Keeley. It's knocked out to center ice. 1 minute 55 to go in the third. Keeley thrown up to the middle ice area. Cobalt off his stick, chipped into the center ice area. Good knock into the zone. What a smart play there by Lamers. Smith Falls with speed, coming through the neutral zone. Walking in on goal, back to the point. The goalie net is empty for Smith Falls. Shoots it through and it hit Cohen's. Sprague looking for the open man, can't find it. They're down the ice. Mayer can't go around Costello. 1:17 on the clock, a 6-5 lead for Desarono. Sprague will dump it in and take a hit. The corner is the captain, Rogalski, in a slick little move there. Back around another man, trying to find an open area. He'll get it, and they call an offside. No goal. Offside, and to boot, it's getting sent down to the other end of the ice. What a turn of events.
Wow, did you see what happened?
I just saw the offside. What did I miss? What happened?
Looks like it was offside, I guess.
Oh, sorry. I thought you meant there was something else that had happened.
Oh, no.
Yeah, it was just by a fraction of a millimeter. It was offside. The crowd won't like it, and the team won't like it, but they're gonna call a timeout for Smith Falls, but it was an offside.
That's a huge break for the Ritos right there, just by a hair.
Oh, it was just a tiny, tiny fraction.
But you know what, though? I got to say, Rogalski with his puck handling right there.
Oh, my.
He was like puck handling in a phone booth.
That was. I thought there was a delayed penalty coming or something. That's why he was so relaxed. But he's just calm as a...
He was stick handling like a knife through butter.
He really was. I got, without Beasley and Witzel in the lineup, it's not that they can't, and it's not that they're not doing any good or anything, but you can completely see the difference in Smith Falls. They're not able to take it to them offensively.
Yeah, and they definitely add those defense, those basically two-way element that, you know, the Ritos possess, and they've had all season. So missing him in a big game like this is definitely a factor, but you know what? Everybody has to step up, and it doesn't matter.
Well, Smith Falls looking for their last opportunity here, and a stop again by Corey Kuypers. Sprague at the point, looking for a lane. There is nothing towards that net. The amount of players there you could fill a school bus with. And it goes up into the mesh with 43 seconds to go. 6-5, Desarono. This crowd is loving it. And on the edge of their seat, at the draw here is Pilon, Jack Cobalt, McKenney, Sprague. The draw comes to Dowdall to Sprague. He keeps it in, throws it down low. Smart play, but Hill's there first as Pilon had fallen. He'll throw it back to Dowdall. Slot and a stop. Kuypers scores. Yep, it's in. It's tied at 6. And I can't believe it. Neither team will give up.
And that offside became crucial.
It was huge, absolutely huge. And to move it 150 feet down the ice, really to the dismay of the Bulldogs, that they never got it out again. It never came out of the zone.
And, you know, you get a feel for the Bulldogs faithful right now. They were 30 seconds away from coming out with the W, but now we're back at square one and looking at possibly overtime, unless we get a buzzer beater.
I didn't even know it went in. I couldn't tell if it had got behind him. It's a nice play, great grind. Holy pulled, and Smith Falls shows the resilience of a team that's worthy of going to the finals. But Desarono is forcing the issue now on Smith Falls with 15 seconds to go and a big turnover, trying to go to the slot. What a spin! Slotty can't get the handle. It's down the ice, and that'll be an icing as well. No, Kuiper's come out to play it. Back to the point. He shoots! Oh, my word! Wow! We are going to overtime, folks, again. And if my hair hasn't gone gray yet, I don't ever know when it will.
Well, Billy, it's going to start sometime, and maybe it's today.
All right, when we come back, Justin will have his guys who he thinks going to snipe. And stay with us, folks. This is an intense game, and it should definitely, of course, be decided in overtime. We'll be back. Four games and 60 minutes down, and we still don't have a representative for the finals to face the Gananoque Islanders. Two combatants, very deserving to punch their ticket to represent their side, but we've got one goal left. Who will get it first? We have absolutely no idea. Both teams putting it all on the line. And Justin Allery has got the game winner in his mind. For each side, who do you pick tonight, Justin?
Oh, my. You know, honestly, I'm going to go with my boy Brett Costello on the blue line for Smith Falls. You know, he's going to probably have a nice little floater going in. And I'm going to go with the heel here, Zach Masterson, for the Deseronto Bulldogs. We know he loves to crash that net and get those garbage goals.
Sprague will complete the hat trick, and if he doesn't, Austin Eastman's pumping the last one in. You know what? If he plays, I'm going with Troy Wiley. If he plays in this overtime, he's going to get the last goal for the Deseronto Bulldogs. And if he does, there's 12 people behind me that will just flip right out, I guarantee you that.
Did they influence that decision?
I hope so. I'd like to see him. Every time he's on the ice, he has an influence on the play, but I could notice he wasn't on the ice in that period. But it's difficult when you've got a lineup like Deseronto does.
Yeah, it's... I'm expecting to probably be a little more crowded here very shortly.
So in that period, the shots on goal were in favor of Smith Falls, 20-10. The total shots in this game are 61 shots by the Smith Falls Ritos, 51 for the Deseronto Bulldogs. Goals in that period were too many. I can't get it in before this puck drop, and this place comes to their feet and starts losing it already. Hill behind the net, the puck skips on him, and Smith Falls will try and gain the zone. Noah Brandt throwing his body around early. The long pass goes down, and an icing will come back to the Deseronto zone. Not their friend in this game, as an offside came all the way back to their zone for a draw and tied this game up with less than a minute to go in the third period. The draw with Sprague leading the charge. Eastman on the Deseronto side. One back, and the Bulldogs of control. Throws it on the half boards, and Hines goes in to get it. Back to the point, and a shot wide of the net. Goes around to the corner to Dowdall. Back to the point, and a shot through, stop up to Hill. Or Hines, the break pass to Brandt, just out of his reach. Throws it back to the point. Dowdall has great speed, but he'll leave it for Sprague. Sprague, Dowdall, stop by Kuipers. Austin Eastman turns in his own zone, spins back, gets out of the way of Brandt, and there's a line change coming. A great pass over. Hines in on goal, drop, shoots! Oh! Hill just about had that one, and they'll get it back. Hill, the half wall to the slot! And he couldn't find the marker on that one. Brandt tries to throw it in front, and he can't, and it goes back the other way. Smith falls with speed. Cobalt tries to go around him. A smart play by Johnny Hill. To Austin Eastman. He's got good speed in. He waits a little long, and it goes into the feet
of Tremblay. Eastman throws it back, hits the ref, and they're out the other way now. With two attackers for Smith Falls. Shot, and it goes wide, deflects, and goes around the net. And back the other way they come. Miracle, the drop to Cannons, to Miracle. Stop by Slack, the rebound's there. And he'll hold on for the whistle. Unbelievable action in this overtime, back and forth.
This is great pace, and it's good to see it coming. It's been, you know, these periods have usually started off pretty slow, but they want to finish this thing quick and very fast.
They want possession right off the draw, and Cannons is the man to do it for Deserano. He'll lose it, and he'll go back to Costello, to the half boards. Kept in, Cannons throws it in behind the net. Miracle will meet it. Back to Miracle again. No, he can't hold on. What a sick. Latasek. Turned over. Mayer throwing it back to Hill. He'll throw it behind the net. Rogalski just missed that one. And Cannons gains the blue line. Every play now is a chance for a goal. Knocked in front of the net. Knocked off the puck and regains it. Out of the Ritos. Costello. Through his own zone, being threatened by Masterson. It's chipped in. Cowens gathers the puck, cycles it back the other way. Rogalski off the glass and up to Zach Masterson. A chip through his legs. He's in. Shot! Hits a leg. Comes to the slot. Backhander. What another beautiful block. And it's back the other way for the Ritos. Doubt all across the blue line. Snipes a shot. It goes up into the mesh, and it'll be inside the zone. It's off a Bulldogs defender. The back and forth action in this game heats up every single possession. And to know who's going to win this game, you'd have to be able to tell the future, because neither one of these teams give an inch, and they're so well matched. It's at the point now. A DDD pass. Tremblay avoids the man, and he shoots it. Just goes wide of the net. It sticks caught up in Sprague. It's knife to the half wall, to the blue line, and out. Regroups. Chipped up. Arnberg knocked off the puck, but they regain it. Good play there to go through his legs. He gains the blue line. Little toe drag. Looking to the slot. He'll find Johnny Hill. Shot. Hits a stick. Off the glass, and it stays in play. Masterson tracks that puck down. Sauce pass to the point, and it's on the tape. Knock. What a defensive effort by Arnberg. Unreal. He's been great for all five games of these playoffs. Why should he be any different now? Masterson throws it ahead. That stick come up and got him in the mouth. No call. Masterson finds the open man in front. Up and over the net. Comes down to a Deserano stick. And the net is off his pegs. That high stick could have resulted in a two-minute power play for for Smith Falls.
Yeah, very fortunate there that they're very, very, very fortunate here that penalty wasn't called, because that was definitely that was very evident of a high stick.
100%. Had the head snap back and everything. Hines on the half boards beats Costello to the puck. He'll try and walk out. He can't. Cobalt loses the puck. Tremblay moves it up, and they're out the neutral zone. It's dumped in, but Rogalski's he couldn't get there first, but he'll get the puck back. And Deserano moves out with good speed. Good play there by Hines. He'll slow up and wait to find a hole. Beautiful move there. Gains the blue line. He's in. He'll snap it on net, and it goes wide. Rogalski trying to track that puck down, and he can't. And they'll leave that one outside the zone. We'll have a face-off. 15:45 in the first OT remaining. And this crowd.
It feels nervous.
Oh my, does it ever. Draw. One back. Keeley. DDD pass to Tremblay. Chipped into the zone. Rogalski. Always sure-footed with that puck. He makes a great play to Cowens. He's got a bit of room to get around. Oh, he did. Watasek. Chipped off the puck, and Cowens will regain it for Deserano. Now, and Miracle couldn't make the play there. Thrown up, and they gain the zone. The shot hits a leg and goes into the corner. Cannons trying to move him out, and he can't. Sift pass out in front of that net. They tried to throw it behind again. Walking out, chance here. Good defensive play. And they'll gain the zone and keep it. It's run around the boards. Mayer will chip it out to center ice. The excitement of this crowd. Smith Falls. Good play there to get on his stick, moving out through center. A good body check by Miracle. Force the issue, make him hear footsteps up and into the mesh, and it'll come down for a draw inside the DiZerano zone.
Yeah, Garrett opened up with a lot of offensive opportunities. Now he's kind of slowed down a bit. Teams are playing a little bit more conservative, but the opportunities and the scoring chances will come very soon.
Fire Wagon Hockey has slowed down a little bit here. Masterson loses the draw. Good hit on McKinney in the boards. Knocked down this. Yeah, bodies flying everywhere. We might have a break. In on goal, Lamers. Masterson shoots and stopped by Dallas Slack. Thrown back down low. Good lift by Masterson. Goes to the blue line. Tries to get it down low. He loses that puck. Back the other way they come. McKinney passes to the slot area. Knife. Dowdle shot, and Kuypers comes up big again. The points wide open. Northgrave, a D-to-D pass. They're both open. Costello finds Dowdle. Kuypers again with a great save. Northgrave, cross pass over to Costello. It's down low to Sprague, looking in front of that net. Oh, they won't call that. And it's back the other way for Lamers. He's been great for them this whole series. He'll dump it in and make a line change. And Smith Falls, Costello, the pass on the boards to McKinney. Thought he'd be pressured a little more. He got into the slot area, but he's thwarted, and it's up through center, and it just hops off his stick. Dowdle throws it in. Kuypers, oh, hold on for the whistle, as he had Cobalt bearing down on him there.
You can just feel the air getting sucked out of this building right now. Just the nervousness in the air, and this is what overtime hockey's all about.
Imagine what's going to happen if DiZerano scores. This crowd will blow the roof off of this place.
And then in comes the oxygen.
Absolutely. Another face-off inside the DiZerano zone. Eastman wanting this one, and he won't get it. Cobalt towards the net, and a great save by Kuypers to steer it out to Hines. Hines being harassed. He gains the line in the zone. Turns back, looks to the point. Hill shoots it towards the net. Great save by Dallas Slack. And he shovels it into the corner. Cobalt back behind the net to the point, and it's out. And down the ice for an icing. We'll bring her back to the Smith Falls zone with 13:10 to go in this overtime period. It couldn't get more intense than this game. Game 5, winner, take all, going to the finals. Represent your conference and make your fans proud. Eastman wins it. Brandt shot, stopped by Noah Slack, or by Dallas Slack. The half boards and they're out. Good move there, dumps it in. McKinney stepped on his stick and fell. No call. They are putting the whistles away. They got too many guys out of the zone. Into the slot, and great deflection. A fantastic play by Arnberg, as they had too many guys in the neutral zone on that one.
I was lucky that puck went, it got redirected out.
Really did. The turnover sent in a 3-on-2. The Ritos send out a fresh five. Fresh five for the DiZerano side. I'm still looking for Wiley, the guy I picked as the goal for the overtime. They're not giving me my chance for my golden pick. Oust Justin is the victor from last week. Back around the net, McKinney looking into the slot to Dowdall. He was wide open, but they're back the other way now with three of them. Here comes Mayer. Crafty, 81, tried to get through him. He'll control the puck, and it's in front! A quick whistle, and I didn't see it.
I look like some arms went up for a moment there, but...
Sure did. The puck is at the face-off circle. They say play on. 12:29 left. These two teams just delivering an epic game to this jam-packed crowd here at the Dog Pound. The draw's won for Smith Falls. It's around the net. Miracle, the first DiZerano Bulldog, and he hits them along the boards, and they're in on goal. Boyce Clair shot, and a stop by Kuypers. Good play into the corner. Shot from the points, knocked down into the slot. Shot and a stop by Kuipers. What a save. Drilled along the wall to the slot. Good effort there by Patterson. Holding on to the wall, and it's back to the point, and it's shot through, deflected around to the other side. Costello at the point. How many overtime games have been decided on just a shot from the point? That's knocked down the ice 200 feet, and we'll bring it back. A shot from the point, I got to be honest with you, would be the best thing for either side right now.
Yeah, I mean, that's the safest play to make right now. Get the puck towards the net. Hope it hits a body in front and redirects and hits Twine.
100%.
Mayer, good draw, man. He'll try and beat Sprague. He's been tough to beat tonight, but he will. Rogalski around the boards. Miracle, it hits something. He's interfered with, but they're out with it. And it's Mayer to Cannons. Looking for Mayer. He shoots it, and Slack will stop that one and hold on to the whistle. Goaltenders are insane in this game. Calm as anything.
Yeah, and, you know, again, these goaltenders, it's a 6-6 game. And look at those shots on goal. It's huge.
Well over 100 shots in total. Shot deflected into the slot area, and Dallas Slack didn't see it. Rolls all the way down to the ice. And that's coming back for a faceoff inside the Smith Falls zone. Do you believe it, folks? Keep your eye on the prize, because it could be taken away at any moment if you're a Rideau's fan or a Bulldogs fan.
Don't blink or you'll miss.
You will. Masterson trying to shovel it back and he can't. And they're out one-handed by Sprague. Very crafty, number 76. He's knocked down. The offside is taken away. Masterson off the glass and into the neutral zone. Bringing it in. Keeley shot on Kuipers. A beautiful, smart play. But Kuipers is just impressing me every single moment of this game. Ever since he's come in, it's given Deserano a chance to win every moment.
You know, he's got a lot to prove, and he's proving a lot of doubters wrong right now.
Young little fan there with a pretty nice message to the Bulldogs. Maybe that'll give them the lift they need to move on to the finals. Off the glass and down the ice. Can't get it past that red line. They'll try again. Sure-footed Johnny Hill throws it around the boards. Chipped up in the air, and they'll keep it in the zone. Knifed into the corner. Deserano will get there first. It's thrown down the ice. Masterson may have a chance here. Masterson stopped by Dallas. Oh, baby, and he's on top of him. Oh, my goodness. Masterson, every game, he is a menace to the opposition. And he can't get out of the goal crease. If anything, he's entertaining, Justin.
he definitely is. He reminds me of Brendan Gallagher a bit, and he just took another shot.
And he could draw Smith Falls into a penalty here. Listen to this crowd.
Is he going to call something?
The refs do not want to call penalty and have this game decided, this series decided by a power play.
Oh, look, Costello there is having words with Pipers.
I don't think they're making dinner reservations.
Maybe looking at the, handshake line at the end of the game.
There's Lamers coming down to protect his goalie, wondering why the captain's talking to their netminder. And I don't think that he's going to like the response. And yeah, he's given it to him pretty good. 92. He played about 15 games this year, and I'm telling you, in the playoffs, he's been one of the best players on the blue, red, and white.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, I'm watching both goalies' body language right now, and you can tell that they're both heated right now.
So no penalties on either side.
You know what, though? Let them play.
Yeah, no, I am 100% on board. I know they're trying to draw one, but it ain't going to happen. You just got to play the game and hope the puck goes in the net, because you're not getting a power play.
You know, I got to give Dallas Slack a lot of credit here. He's really held his composure.
He has. He's been run a couple times. So has Kuipers. But
he looked towards the official with his glove off and saying, what am I supposed to do here?
Back behind the net on a big hit. That.
No!
This should be one guy. And we got stuff here too, Justin. They're going to wreck this power play here.
We got the trainer on the ice, unsung hero of the league, of the Desert Arnold Bulldogs. That's a really bad penalty take at this point in time. A deliberate cross check to the back. That's a really, that's a selfish penalty. You got to be a lot more disciplined than that.
And it was not only the hit, he jumped on him afterwards to guarantee that he was taken two and maybe four.
Yeah.
But it could be, yeah, it's... No, they're not taking a Desert Arnold Bulldog. That is smart. That is a great call by the refs. Because if you take one from either side, then both sides believe in a situation like that, it's not going to hurt me, so why not finish the check?
Well, exactly, right? And, I mean, that's a dangerous play that just happened. Like, he was defenseless in that situation, in a vulnerable position. Just can't do that. And here I am sounding like a referee. You can't do that.
Can't do that. 2 minutes.
14, get out of the game. 14.
And that was Arnberg. It's going to be McKinney going for 2 minutes. Arnberg was the guy who was taken down. He's the guy they have on the power play always with Hill. So how will this affect the Bulldogs on the power play with him hurt?
Bulldogs here have such a great depth. They can insert anybody in the lineup. But, you know, Arnberg...
That little girl right there with that little message there is go, Bulldogs, go, and her favorite player on it as well. Hopefully that gives them the edge to get this W here for the hometown crowd.
You can just feel the buzz in there. They just want this game to be over.
Draw back, Johnny Hill on it quick. What a slick pass to Arnberg. He is on the ice towards the net into the corner. Back to Arnberg. They're set up now. Three at the point, though. Nobody in front of the net trying to get it into the corner. Hines looking back to the point, and he'll get it. Arnberg straddles the line to Johnny Hill. Nobody in front of the net. Down into the corner. Chops it away. Eastman to the point. Johnny Hill over to Arnberg to Hill the shot, and it hits a stick into the slot again. Brandt shot and a stop again, knocks it off his stick. They contain the puck, and Eastman on the half boards will throw it back to Hill. Shoots, knocked away by Dallas Slack, the man almost sitting in his lap. Behind the net it goes. Brandt, it hops over Hines' stick. He's into the corner. Looking to the point. Now he goes back down low to Brandt. Brandt shovels it. He's hit against the boards. And Costello will drill it down the ice. And Kuypers has got to come out to play it. Kuypers. Good play. Beauty by Kuypers to Hill. It hits his foot. Over there is Lamers. Masterson chips it up. Lamers. He's got Masterson with him. Lamers. Oh. And it just goes astray. And Sprague's back the other way. Walking in, shoots, and a beautiful glove save by Corey. That's a hard save to make.
Especially on that angle, you're not necessarily in position like you would be if you were square to a shooter that's coming on you straight in. They've been really testing him on those sharp angles.
The third or fourth one he's made like that in this game.
I don't know if these shooters are seeing something that that maybe he's deliberately giving them to force them to shoot that way. He's looking sharp as ever.
Just as sharp as a tack. It's unreal goaltending. The blue, red, and white. Dallas Slack countering him. Save for save. Who's going to break through? Miracle. Mayer. Hill. Cannons. And there is Arnberg. After that hit behind the net, he's fresh as a daisy. 20 seconds to go on the power play. They got to move it out and gain the zone. Taking a little bit long. Arnberg gets the neutral zone and gives it over to Cannons. Cannons throws it into the slot. Tried to get it on net and it goes astray. Fans talked Hill into staying back on that one. Miracle to the half boards, keeping it low and containing the puck. It's a 5-on-5 and he was away. That's an icing. That was very dangerous.
That was absolutely very dangerous.
Out of the box, there was no notification. When there's a penalty against Dallas Slack and his Ritos, you hear that stick about 40 times, and you can hear it throughout this arena. I didn't hear anything, and Deserano didn't allow their defense to know that there was someone coming out of that box.
Yeah, you know, I know one thing I do in Frontenac is I like to have the have a little sound go off. Yes, a little Mario mushroom when you're full strength.
Good play to get it out of the zone. Smith Falls will shovel that back in, and Rogalski into the corner and throws it back behind the net. Trying to make a nice pass up, and they will convert. Noah Brandt to the blue line. The pass over to Eastman. Shoots. Stopped by Slack. Costello over to McKinney. Through the zone. In on goal. The shot, and he ripped it up over the net. Come back down to a Bulldog stick. Rogalski just missed Noah Brandt. Brandt needs a line change. And there's a guy behind the net hurt. That'll help Brandt. He needed to get off the ice. I didn't see what happened to Dowdall, but he's hurt. And it'll be a draw inside the Smith Falls zone with 7 minutes and 22 seconds to go. Zach Masterson on the ice to take the draw. At his points, the captain, Rogalski. And we'll see what they can do here in the final stages of this wonderful 5-game series. In, shot, and it hits a stick, goes up into the glass. Lamers off the boards to Masterson, a smart play. The sift over, across, in his feet. Onto the half boards, goes to the point, and it is covered again. And they got it to the slot. They won't get it on net. Trying again, he holds it a little long, chips it in, second effort. McKinney, taken off the puck, shot, and a save by Slack. What a play by Masterson to get that one. Masterson a little loose with the stick, could have got a penalty on a trip there. It's knifed away from him to the corner. Way to get in the way of him there, that could have been interference. Masterson misses him there. And Smith Falls is out through center ice. They dump it in on Kuypers. He'll hold on to that bouncing puck with 6 1/4 to go here in the third period, farther than the overtime period. Holy Mackinac, this is unreal. Sorry, Joe Bowen, that's yours. I do apologize. Trademark is in suit. Can't tell who that is on the draw for Deseron. It looks like Mayer. And he'll win it back, but it's right onto the tape. They're around the net with a wraparound. It gets stuck on the post to the point. Shot through, and Kuypers, like a catcher catching a ball low, holds on to that one.
I gotta say, I'm surprised the net didn't pop off.
That only happens for one goalie in the league, Justin.
Yeah, and he's gonna be there tomorrow.
It's gonna be a wild game. I don't know how they'll have any energy for the next game.
Well, especially, you know, we're closing in on possibly 2 overtimes so far.
Dowdall from the point shoots up into the wood, and it'll come down for a draw. Yeah, 6:07 to go here in this overtime, and it's at a stalemate. Both teams can't beat these goalies right now.
I tell you, Billy, my arm is tired from following the play with the video here.
James, we need you. We need you back. His one arm is massive. Drop back to the point. Shot through a screen. Kuypers will find that and steer it out of direction of the net. And it's out with Hines turning back. They need to get control. And they got it. Moving it in with good speed. Into the corner. Behind the net it goes. Looking to the point. He stops and falls. Tripped and fell. Back to the point. Hill towards the net. And Dallas Slack will snap that one out of the air and hold on for a whistle. I'm running out of liquid here, Justin.
I think I have a Gatorade in my bottle for you, Billy, if you need it.
Perfect. Thank you. It's not stolen? It didn't get stolen from you, I mean?
Well, I'm still, you know, we're still waiting on recovery of the two protein bars and the and the 2 Gatorades that were stolen. So
100%. Draw to the point. Arnberg shot. Into the slot, it's, it could have been up over the glass. Would have been 2 minutes. Pilon, his own zone, the pass over. Costello, the quarterback, over to McKinney. McKinney knocked off the puck by Brandt. Long ice pass, not going to work on that one. Trying to knock it down, thrown into the corner. Picked up by Smith Falls of the slot, and it's knocked down by Kuypers. Eastman, back the other way, he comes on goal. It could be it. Back, what a save by Dallas Slack. Unreal save.
Hey, what do we say? He plays shortstop in baseball, so that does not surprise me at all.
Not at all. These saves by the goalies are so awkward. The angles, they're such weird plays, and they're finding a way to make the save. It's beautiful hockey. Now Zach Masterson at the draw, trying it. The scrum draw, he kicks it back to the point, and through a screen, the shot hits a leg.
That was a smart play by Masterson on the draw.
Behind the net, and Lamers pinching up against the boards against Boise Clair, trying to get it back to the point, and a bit of a mistake.
What a sick to Kuypers.
He'll hold on to that one for a draw. 4:40 to go, folks. If you are not entertained, I don't know how to help you.
Face off with Andrew Sprague at the draw. He's got Tremblay back to the right. He's got McKinney to his right as well. He wins it to Rogalski. Deserano
moving it out of their own zone, playing for their season. Just out of the reach of Masterson. It gets to the blue line. It's kept in by Rogalski. And it's going to be an offside. Just outside the zone. Good effort by the captain. He thought it was okay.
Hey, some people here probably played basketball at some point in high school, right?
He's tall enough.
I can tell you one thing, Rogalski, he is a tough SOB. And I mean, I'm being polite. He is. I will tell you, like, when I was coaching against the Bulldogs earlier this season, he was a pest on the ice.
Back to Rogalski. Rogalski through the middle of the ice. And Miracle is in. The pass over. Gets knocked down a bit, but Cannons regains it. Circling. Throwing to the... Oh, my. Dowdall. A break. Away. Slot. Score! Smith Falls will march on. To the dismay of this Deserano Bulldogs. What an unbelievable game. And the Smith Falls Ritos will face the Gananoque Islanders tomorrow in Gan. And I'll tell you, folks, this is a very unhappy Deserano Bulldogs crowd tonight. But they were treated to amazing 76 minutes of hockey, and Smith Falls a very deserving W, but Deserano with an amazing season, they could have won it as well. Justin, what's your take? Wow.
You know, that was definitely a crushing heartbreak for Deserano, as they did have a five game improvement on their record from the regular season, going from a 500 club to a team that's five games over 500, so a very successful year. But you know that they're not satisfied with the result of this round. They would really like to get through to the next round, but you know that they're going to be hungry going into next season, and you know they're going to have a lot of decisions to make as to what they're going to do and who they're going to bring back, and they're not going to bring back. So
they're building a winning franchise here in Deserano, and knowing Corey Kuypers, the way that he played in that game gives him a lot of confidence, having a 1A, 1B goaltending tandem maybe next season. And seeing how Lamers and guys like Wiley played in that game, and I mean, of course, Austin Eastman and those guys, they have a bright future ahead of them. And the Deserano Bulldogs, a class team, who played an incredible game and did a great job in this five-game series. Just come up a little short tonight, but nothing they should be down on themselves about.
No, definitely not. You know, despite, you know, the Ritos here, they really did, defeat all odds here against them. You know, they weren't the favorites here going into the series, but, you know, this game, they were missing some very big key players, and Eric Witzel and Beasley, Ben Beasley. So, you know, to come out with a win like this, it's definitely shows a lot of character in this group. And, you know, they're going to feel pretty good about themselves hanging over to Gann tomorrow.
Well, Smith Falls really put on a defensive clinic against, I would say, one of the most high-powered offense in the league, in the Deserano Bulldogs. But a guy that really needs to be mentioned is Corey Kuypers. coming in a difficult situation, knowing that Bailey Merrickle is one of the best goaltenders in the league. He comes in to replace him and doesn't just do the job, but he does an incredible job. He does an incredible job and gives him a chance to win every game. So hats off to him. But what do you see for Gannon Aukwin and Smith Falls? What type of a series are we going to see in that, Justin?
Well, we know Smith Falls. We know what kind of defensive scheme they have. But they are going to have to play very tightly defensively because we know Gannon Aukwin, they play a very loose offensive game. They cycle the puck very well. They're not afraid to take penalties because their penalty kill is almost as lethal as their power play, as crazy as that sounds. So they're going to have their hands full. And, you know, they've got great goaltending in Jake Command, and also in Leif Hertz as well, who's a southpaw, so he's going to throw shooters off with that. But either way, we're going to be in for a great series. And, you know, Smith Falls, again, I think they're going to have their hands tied. They're going to have to find a way to generate offense in this one.
Well, we're going to have as much action as we can. There's only so many games we can cover, and we can't be in two places at one time. But one place will be tomorrow, South Stormont, as we get our first opportunity in the other conferences. South Stormont, welcome us into their arena, and we're excited to be there.
We're thrilled to be there, and it's going to be a lot of fun, I think. And we get to witness a game with the back-to-back USHL champions as well at the North Dundas Rockets. So be prepared, and we got a surprise interview coming up tomorrow as well.
I can't wait, folks. What a series we were able to bring you here, and what a performance these two teams put on. That's going to do it for us here tonight, folks. Your final score from the Dog Pound, 7-6 for the Smith Falls Ritos. Folks, thanks for tuning in from Justin and myself. Thanks for tuning in. We love bringing it to you. We hope you love it as much as we do. Thanks for tuning in. Bye for now.